follow the king. Town known as Sydney in Australia, rode a boy with a six gun in his hand, and his daring life of crime made him a legend in his time, east and west of the Rio Grande.
I'm hungry. I don't know.
Yes. And I just paid the bill, so you don't have anything to worry about.
Okay. I don't feel well, girl. I don't feel well.
Perhaps. Are you gonna go and lay down?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Maiden Bar! Top of the world!
I can make it home.
Hello, hello, hello! Allie P, thank you for the 5 gifted subs, dude! I missed yous! Welcome to the Dead End Saloon.
Don't worry about me, girls. Let's just...
Hey, how y'all doing? Hey, hey.
I don't know what is happening.
Let me get a stew and a light beer, please.
Okay, you get the beer, I'll get the stew.
All right.
Deal.
Oh man, gotta get those 70s, 80s sitcom feels in the intro, why not? I'll go with the blue.
Thank you. How's y'all day been?
All right, how about you?
Can't complain, just got out of Siska, god damn it.
Congrats. Oh, I think
Thank
I saw you.
You
in there, right? Briefly?
What's that? I think so. Yeah, I think so. I was in there for a long fucking time.
What did you do?
And then I got out and then went straight back in. You know how it is.
Oh, yeah?
All right. Ignore
Yeah,
me.
Just one of those things.
I get the feeling.
All right, y'all.
I know the...
Y'all have a good one, all right?
You as well.
Where the Braithwaites go? They were just here. Where did they go?
Hey.
Hi.
How day?
Just a crush.
Hey, Dom.
Good. How did it go?
Well. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, we got about $2,000 from it. Nothing leading
okay.
back to us. We're fine.
Okay. No one got hurt.
No. clean as a whistle, you know. Well, the thing is, his plan was fucking horrendous. Horrendous.
I told you.
That's all right. I ended up convincing him to do one of my plans, and that worked out well.
Yeah, from what I've noticed, most of their plans tend to just be like, shoot our way through.
His plan was literally get someone onto the roof, negotiate, then throw the fella off the roof, and then just hope for the best.
Sounds about right.
Well, we changed that.
Yeah. I think it would be interesting to rob a bank with someone on the roof.
Gin brewery.
But it's going to require some fucking planning.
Yeah, not just hope for the best.
It's fucking horrendous, I swear to God. Don't worry, I fixed it. You know,
man. Okay. Who else was on it?
Are you talking very quietly?
Yes.
Me? Well, actually, you know what? Let's check telegrams.
Okay, I think I sent you one, so it's probably... Well...
Oh, what, you think I only get telegrams from you? What about all my other sweethearts and secret admirers?
Okay, well, you show me those sweetheart telegrams, I'll make sure you never get them again.
I'd be too embarrassed to show you. I would blush.
You'd blush.
So I did a job with, it was Forest Fish.
I thought...
Alice.
Mills and Alice hated...
You know what? Him? I don't know. He changed his name to Miranda or something.
Okay.
And your favorite, James Kelly, was there.
No, you didn't do a job with James Kelly. Tell me it ain't true, all of it.
Oh, I did. And it was, you know, I've got to the point... Listen, I've got to the point in my life where I'm so good at fucking bank jobs that I will take on a massive handicap and I'll take on James Kelly, all right? If I can do a job with James Kelly and get away with it scot-free, no one getting caught, then I can get away with anything, all right? It's been proven time and again.
Please, Richard.
I don't know if he got fucking shot, but he was definitely doing some weird shit.
Man, I wish I could have gone with you.
I know, well, you could have, but you went to sleep.
You did it so late.
I did it so... It wasn't my fucking job.
Okay, well, if it was Mills' job, Mills has no concept of time or sleep schedule, so that makes sense.
They took me out to the west. It's fucking sandy. It was terrible. Terrible.
The dinner is tonight.
You called Richard? Yep. Alright, well, you know, we'll... When?
Not 100% sure.
Mo's around?
Yeah, also I got a telegram from Amber. She's around for Frankie's funeral, I guess.
Waking around.
So, I'm definitely gonna try to see her.
Alright, well, just make sure I'm gonna be there, right?
When I see Amber?
No, the dinner.
Yeah, I think...
Yeah, alright.
Yeah. Also, I'm very, very happy to see Mo.
Yeah, so am I. I need a piano player. I've been missing my pianist. Huh?
He's so good, right?
He is very lovely. I feel like he gets upset, though, when I ask him to play the piano. Like, I say, play the piano, and he'll give me, like, this tone, like, all right. But then it'll sound like he's not all right with it, and that he feels like he's being, like, What's the word?
I don't know the word. Coerced?
No. Used? I feel like he feels like he has more to offer than just being a penis.
Oh, okay. Fair. Well, I can ask him in a nicer way, maybe.
You don't think I'll say it in a nice way? Are you fucking kidding me right now?
No, probably not.
I'm a people person.
You're a people person.
Where's Pete? Oi! Where's Pete?
Oi!
I don't know.
All right, I don't have to fucking yell. All right, Jesus.
I haven't seen
him. Yeah, people person.
Okay, all right.
Where'd Mo go?
He went out the back. Question.
I was
gone for 2 seconds.
Yeah, you're around here a lot, right? You're like a regular.
Cheshire, yeah?
You don't have a badge now, do you?
She went on me?
No, but that's not what I'm asking. Do you, are you a lawman?
No, not a chance.
Yeah, all right. Do you believe him?
Me? What? Yeah? Huh?
I'm asking both of y'all.
What?
Hey.
Yeah, sure, why not? I believe him.
He could be spying on us.
That's true.
He could be, but also we don't talk about anything, so...
Well, he looks a little bit like Malone.
Oh my god.
Good morning. Hello.
Do I sound like Malone?
I met Dakota.
I don't think that works.
I met Dakota in Shishika.
That's true. That did happen.
Malone's how many lawmen have you seen?
Marty?
I saw Marty walking down the street earlier, and then I came in the saloon, and then he was up there playing blackjack, so I don't think that works out.
All right, there's only one way to find out if he is Marty Malone. Stand up straight. I'm going to put an end to this right now.
He did order gin.
I did.
Yeah, but Malone asked for whiskey because it's the closest to bourbon.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Is this real?
What do you mean,
is that real?
Malone don't have no eyebrows.
Fucking eyebrow.
Alright, they seem to be real. It looks like it's real hair.
Hey. Oh.
He passed the eyebrow check. Alright then.
He still could be a minion for Malone.
Just keep an eye on that.
It's possible.
Okay.
Who's Malone?
What's under your hat, hmm? You got a real tall hat.
Yeah, what is under your
hat?
What
kind of secrets do you hide under there?
My hair. And my head.
Let's find
your
out.
Hair or your lack of hair?
Yeah!
Oh, he's got a full head of hair.
Full head, yeah.
Right.
Hold on,
right.
Can you let me go?
Yeah, I'll let you go.
Free hair.
Ow!
Alright, fine. Alright, it checks out. Alright, have a drink on us. Apologies.
Oh, okay.
Oh! Fuck. Detective Wallaby?
Hi.
There you are.
Hello.
Thank you.
Allie, thank you for the fucking subs. Wombo
hello.
Combo?
Hello. that actually works.
Hey, for 10 months. Sonic 2 on DVD. Thank you for the 7 months in a row.
It's a little big for your head, but...
It's also really difficult to wear hats with this hair because I gotta stuff my little bun up there. And then there's only the scraggly pieces coming down. And so it looks like I just got scraggly hair.
Well,
but, you know, hat's a free hat.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You could like, you know, put a comb through your hair once in a while.
That's true. Sometimes, you know.
I could.
You could.
I got a horse brush you could use.
Do you want me to?
No, I don't care. I take your ball if you're bald.
Are you sure?
Probably.
Oh, that's nice.
They got lovely wigs nowadays.
I guess I could brush my hair, but most of the time when I brush my hair, the brush breaks.
Right.
I ain't found a good brush yet.
Huh. Right. Okay, all right. Does anyone know? So Mo just left, did he? God damn, I thought I found my penis.
I went outside to...
Your penis?
He did play for somebody earlier. The Braithwaite. He did great job.
You know, I'm getting real sick and tired of this juvenile behavior. I say penis, and you all are talking about dicks. I'm fucking sick of it.
No, I was talking about a penis.
He's
making these leaps. Also, did you?
What's so funny, Peaches?
Well, I'm gonna go find my penis right now, right?
Simple piano playing.
Come back, this is an important question.
Is it really an important question, though?
It's a really important question. No, come back. I have to ask you with Dakota.
Oh, you gotta ask me in front of everybody so they can laugh, right? Question. Yeah, go ahead.
What question? Which one? There are so many!
Have you looked at Edwin's hemorrhoids by any chance?
Listen, I don't want to talk about this, alright?
Oh my god, so it's true!
Listen, we're doing some time together, alright? And he was in pain, and he said, Wallaby, can you just have a look real quick? And I looked over, and he had his trousers down, bent over. It wasn't very fucking pretty, right?
Oh my god.
Are hemorrhoids, like, inside of you? How deep?
No, something had definitely popped out, and it was fucking disgusting.
What the
oh my
fuck?
God.
Did you gaze into his third eye?
I don't want to talk about this no more, all right?
Okay.
We'll talk about it no more. Oh, look who it is. It's the Golden Goose.
Hi, Adelaide.
Hi, Adelaide.
Adelaide.
Yes?
What the fuck?
I know a new move. Can I show you? Come here.
Yeah, all right. You show me a new move.
What question?
All right.
Let's
you know
see.
My friend Lady?
Lady, no, I don't.
She showed me this move. Hold on.
That's fantastic. Lovely. What are you doing?
Feast your eyes. On the new move. Do you like it?
You know what? It's actually not too bad. What do you call it?
I don't know yet.
I think you call it. What time is it?
That's right. All right, I like that.
What's that song? What is it? Tell me that song. I need help. I need to play a song.
Lady showed me that move. It's like a very sensual type of move.
Yes, I think that actually might be a seller.
Really?
Yes, I really do.
You think they should pay more?
No.
Oh.
You guys don't know the song, man. I don't even know what it is. All right. Well, let me see the smile.
Oh. Cheese.
That's my girl. Look at that. Beautiful. All right. Mm-hmm. All right. Make sure to powder yourself up, and I think we're gonna test out that dance today.
All right.
All right.
I'll get my powder.
What's the name of that fucking song, man?
Oh my god.
It's happening to me now.
Well, thing with shivers.
Candy shop?
I don't think so.
Candy shop?
Shivering and keeling over.
Shivering is absolutely normal. Absolutely normal.
If it is, I'll be blown away.
Yeah, ask Wallaby.
Wallaby.
Ask Wallaby.
He'll say the same thing.
Wallaby.
What?
Have you ever shivered when you pee?
No.
Okay.
What?
See?
I do not believe you. Not even for a second.
You have slept with Dakota, right?
Okay,
that explains that there's something definitely wrong. Go check that out.
Before
maybe
that.
Just
people who hang on. Is it the song? Hold on. Oh my god, it is! Yes! Hey. Alright, let me see. Okay, come over here. We're gonna practice this dance.
Alright!
Fuck, it is. Alright, show me what time is it. Hang on.
Oh.
Hey, don't fellas. How you doing? Welcome to the Dead End Saloon.
Oh, nice. How are you doing today?
Yeah, well.
What a lovely
welcome,
place.
Welcome, sir.
Thank you very much.
Welcome in.
It's a very excellent establishment.
What kind of drink?
Thank you.
A stiff one.
Hi, Mr. What can I get for you?
Would y'all like
some
a drink?
Scotch whiskey.
Scotch whiskey sounds lovely. No, thank you, love.
Thank you.
You're very pretty, though.
Thank you.
She just invented a brand new dance that's never been seen before. She's eager
that's
to show some lovely fellas, if you're interested.
Brand new dance, you say?
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm. Never seen
Enjoy.
Before.
Well, I'm very
thank
sure Kelton would love that, wouldn't you, Kelton?
There's some bouncing involved, I'll tell you that much right now.
It's to die for.
Kelton, I saw you, mate.
Sir, anything?
$50 for the private dance.
Scottish whiskey, please, my friend.
Absolutely. Here you are.
Thank you very much.
Lovely eye patch you got on there. That'll be $5 for you.
Hospitality in this place is very nice.
Sorry about your name. Enjoy. And you, sir, anything for you?
Yep.
I can tell you want that dance, fella. I can tell by the cut of your jib.
Considering it.
That's right. $50, you'll get a lovely dance, a never seen before dance. She just invented it.
Never seen before.
And I'm telling you right now, it will blow your mind.
What do you say? You're handsome.
All right. Why not?
All right. $50 will take you to the dance area.
He's going to be a very happy man tonight.
Oh.
It's even better when you're drunk.
It
just
is.
Saying.
Enjoy yourself, Kelton. You deserve it.
Yeah, come on,
no, I will. I'll take a whiskey.
Yeah, grab yourself a whiskey. Absolutely. And come upstairs. Charge more. We might have to. This is a good one.
What do you call this place?
Dead End Saloon.
How much will that be?
This is why you're my golden girl. I told you, say, because you go the extra mile. You've come and invented something special.
I certainly
love
shall.
I'm glad you like it.
I can't wait for him to see it.
I mean, honestly, it was Lady's idea. She came up with it.
Yeah, sure.
Are you nervous?
That's what you gotta take credit for everything. What are you doing?
You're looking a little
nervous. Oh, right.
It was your idea.
I came up with it.
That's right.
I think I have the whiskey.
What do they call that?
What was the guy's name again?
Courage.
Give this man a whiskey. Come on now.
Oh, I have one. He's got the whiskey.
All right, this way, sir.
All right.
Come on.
Have fun, friend.
All right, have a seat right here.
That's the place this is. Right here. All right, let me see.
All right, get up on that table. You gotta run and get up on that table.
This is certainly special already.
All right. Now show him what time it is.
Sir, feast your eyes on the best dance you'll ever see.
Hold on. Where's the watch? Where's the watch?
It's in my hand.
No, it's not. Get the watch out. No, get the... Did you see a watch?
I do not see a watch.
Get off the table. I think you're fucking head off. Get off the table.
Oh.
All right, try it out. Get the watch out. No, what the fuck?
You don't see the watch?
No. Just wait there, sir. We're having some difficulties. What the fuck are you doing?
Right,
what are you doing?
Hey, now.
No, this man paid $50. What are you doing?
I don't know what you're talking about. I have the watch.
Are you calling me blind? You calling your customer blind?
No, I'm not.
Drop the watch.
Am I blind?
Pick it back up. Do something.
Sir, patience, please.
She's still learning the new technique. You're just gonna have to give her.
It's a very interesting technique.
You showed me the fucking dance. Why can't you? What, you have it with stage fright? What's going on?
No, I'm done. I have the watch.
Okay, let me see it. No, you.
What do you see when I do
You're
that?
You're just staring off blankly into the fucking distance.
That don't make no sense.
Well, I'm telling you right now, it makes perfect sense because that's what you're doing and that's what he's saying and that's what matters.
What? Let me go to the powder room real quick.
Yeah, go to the She's just going to go powder her nose for a moment, so yeah, she'll be right back.
Yes, that's quite all right.
Yes, don't mind me. I'm just going to make sure she does it right.
I'll talk to you for a minute because...
I think she's relogging. God damn. Who the fuck are you?
Sir?
Who the fuck are you?
Well, my name's Les. And who the fuck are you?
I run this establishment. Why are you in the girls' changing room?
Sir, I did not realize.
Getting some kind of private hanky-panky show, huh?
I wouldn't mind a private hanky-panky.
Get out to the fucking bar. Get out of the fucking change room.
All right, I'm sorry.
Unfucking believable. It's strictly look, no touch, fella.
I understand.
Goddamn creeping under the bed like that.
Hell, I was just taking a damn nap. I didn't realize this lady got in their undergarment.
Oh my gosh, you live. Jesus.
I know, apparently I am.
Oh, man. Who's that? The fucking... Oop. Oop. I don't know if that's Laura or not. Where the fuck is she, man? I know that the watch glitches like that. It might not work at all. I'm surprised it worked for me. Fucking headbagger, man. The fuck is she, man? Time is of the essence. Fucking finally. Alright. Alright. Are you good? Are you ready?
Oh, I'm ready.
Alright. Here we go. Pull the watch out.
Here we go. You see the watch?
Yes, I do.
Feast your eyes on the best dance you'll ever see in your life. So, sir, how's your day doing?
There you go.
Today?
Keep it going. Keep it going.
Oh, my God.
You having a great day?
How are you doing that with your neck?
I'm flexible. I'm graceful. And I'm the best dancer in the crossing.
I had no idea you were so talented.
What's your name?
Kelton.
Well, Kelton, you are so handsome. What do you do for work, Kelton?
Oh, I do everything for work.
Oh, like what?
Name something, I do it.
You rob banks?
Have you seen anything move quite like that, huh?
No, never seen something move quite like that.
Keep bouncing.
I'm getting dizzy.
You're not even just keep going.
You're doing well. You're doing fucking great.
I'm definitely getting my $50 worth here.
So, do you have a... Are you married?
No.
Do you want to be?
No.
Well... I could be your best kept secret, Kelton. Is that your name?
It is. Well, so long as you keep doing the dance, I think we could be all good.
Oh, wonderful.
Most wanted, dude.
How come I've never
One of the most notorious outlaws, guys. What is this? This is a free show. Get out of here.
I have to ask you something. There's a fella downstairs that's looking to buy two pairs of handcuffs.
Demons have been summoned him, but I didn't
see. You're right. How much?
I told him that he could probably discuss that with you because I'm not too sure how prices go.
Right, make sure she keeps... Keep fucking bouncing! Make sure she keeps bouncing. I'll be right back.
Okay.
I hear it all the time.
Hi.
Shout to chat who knew that it was candy shop. Alright, someone wanted to talk to me about some kind of deal.
Yeah, I've been...
Alright. Over here, sir.
Yeah.
Alright, what can I do for you?
Well, the best corners for conversations here, haven't you? I want to buy some handcuffs. Two of them.
Yeah, how much you paying?
Well, what's your price? Name it.
$50 each.
All right, that's acceptable. You want gems or you want money?
I'll take cash. We'll go down to the bank. $100. What's that?
$100, yeah.
Correct, yes. We'll go down to the bank. I'll give you the handcuffs. You give me the money.
That works.
All right, let's go. Is it Lauren to cover? Maybe. If it is, it's smart.
You're a wannabe kid, right?
Yeah, that's what they call me.
Yeah, everyone seems to know your name.
Yeah, I've been around. What's your name?
What do you think? Oh, you can call me Doc.
Yeah, pleasure.
Yeah, all mine.
What do you plan on using the cuffs for?
Oh, I've got a boyfriend in that bar. What do you want me to know?
You know what? I don't need to fucking know, alright?
You see, that's the trick. You tell someone something they don't want to hear and they don't ask any more questions.
True.
Well, I think you know exactly what I'm going to use them for.
Yeah, of course.
It's been a long time since I've been doing that kind of stuff, but just getting back into the swing of things now.
Yeah. Of course, yeah. Not going to be a little rusty, huh?
Well, it has been 3 years, so probably, but already done a few things and they've gone quite well.
Oh, good. I'm glad to hear it. You make sure you make some money, you come to the saloon and spend it, right?
Always have been. The coach has been lovely.
She's a gem. All right.
A little tip for the first transaction.
Oh,
and too many more.
Appreciate that, yeah. Definitely. You need anything else, you come to me. Pleasure doing business.
You don't mind me taking your telegram then.
Yeah, Nutsack 591.
Thank you.
Have a lovely day and happy hunting. Good morning to you, sir. Definitely law. Will they arrest me for having cuffs? Bring it, bitch. I'll pay my fine. I can't get that song out of my head. I just went dun, 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 and like you guys helped me. Thank you so much. I wanted to find that song. I thought it was perfect. Fuck.
Is that a layout right?
Oh yeah, she was just showing up a little bit is all.
Okay.
Oh yeah.
Alright, where is she? She going?
She got dizzy and threw up upstairs.
Oh, that's fine.
Or was dry even. I'm not sure how much liquid came out.
Oh, pardon me. All right, how'd you go?
The dance is done. He's very happy.
Did he tip
you? Go, Adelaide.
Oh.
You're gonna tip.
Carlton? Would you like to tip me?
You want me to push you over?
With money?
Why is there a whiskey on the ground?
Yes, I do.
Wow, thank you so much.
How much did he tip her, man? How much did he tip her?
All right, well, thank you kindly for that experience.
Thank you, Kelton.
Anytime.
He tipped me $15.
Oh, lovely. All right.
All right. Thank you for that most memorable experience.
Of course. You want that again. Mm-hmm. You come stop by any time and...
I certainly shall.
Of course. I'm such a
prick. Is this what you want?
What do you think? Of course.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Lovely work.
Oh.
I think that's my new favorite thing that you can do.
Oh. Yeah, I'm sure to bring a lot of money.
We might have to make the normal dance 50, make that 175.
Oh, good idea.
Yeah, that's what we do. Maybe
that's kind of steep.
Well, you don't think it's worth $75?
Hi.
I don't think people have that much.
We'll see. We'll see what they say.
All right.
What time is it? Lovely. I'm not stealing. I'm going to pay it to her husband. The way that he's arranged it and she's okay with it because she's totally abused in her marriage. That's their business.
Hello.
Where did Mo go?
Scale?
Yeah, where did Mo go?
Adelaide.
I've already made like $200 today, man.
All right, how are you?
I wonder if I have his telegram. I'm gonna go check.
I have Mo's telegram.
Oh, do you have it on hand? Can I have it?
No, I don't have it on hand.
I know I got it ages ago, but I don't know if I...
Why did he leave for? I don't understand.
I don't know.
All right, we can go telegram. Let's go.
Maybe he doesn't like me or something.
Yeah. Isn't his fault?
She's the golden goose.
Did you see that bounce she was doing?
Yeah, and her head. That was absolutely impressive.
Yeah, we are charging more for that, that's for sure.
Yeah, that was... Wow. That was quite something. And the customers seemed happy as well.
Oh, yes. She's such a good RPR. Oh, yeah. She's fantastic, man. Lovely. Lovely lass.
Wait, you weren't looking like that hard, right?
No, I was... You know, she's part of the business. Of course.
Yeah.
Well, you know I only have eyes for you.
Oh. Now you gonna make me blush.
Yeah, that's right. I am a romantic.
He's not romantic at all. He just ignores people. Wallaby's purely business 24/7.
So apparently, Edwin's aunt was in the parlor house.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I saw her.
You saw her?
Yeah.
I don't know nothing about his aunt. I didn't even know he had an aunt. I know he had a cousin, Emma.
Oh, no. Okay, I don't fucking know. Why?
I don't know. There's just all of a sudden a lot of them. Oh,
speaking of Braithwaite.
Howdy.
Oh, howdy. It's lovely to meet you all.
Hello, Amy. How you doing?
Annie?
Yes?
What's Mo's telegram?
I'm doing great.
Mo.
It's good. How's your,
probably
your
have
aunt
him here, though.
Oh, she's...
Mo.
She's feeling lively as ever.
Oh, maybe I don't have Mo.
Oh, that's good.
Shit. Mo!
Is everything okay? You seem distressed.
AF86, I remember.
Well, Auntie's just a bit of a handful sometimes. You know, she's quite old.
Oh, yeah?
Yes, and, well, she has the dementia, and, well, she...
Right.
Yeah.
Now, that's very sad. Amy, I'm gonna need that money back, by the way.
Annie, right. How much would you like that?
All of it.
All right. Give me just a moment to finish this telegram, and I'll head
course
to the bank.
I'll come with you. This telegram is AF860.
Okay.
Opportunity awaits. Mine workers. Ah, dude. Yeah, come slave away in the mines, bro. Mm-mm.
I should probably try to talk to the law today to see if we made any progress on the gun situation. People were so paranoid yesterday that Lord knows that it's Wallaby that did the bank job. Everyone in my Discord's like, oh my god. They're busted, man. They know. There's no way the law know, guys. We good. We were clean. In and out. Shit. Wasn't Joe. Clean, bro. You know what I heard? You know, I you didn't hear this from me, but you did. I heard that Smokey, General Smokey, will be dropping a Eddie video on YouTube in the next few days.
All right.
An edited video.
Let's see.
Like he did with Emmett.
How much did you have with me?
I'm sure you have that written down somewhere.
Yes, I think it was about $500, wasn't it?
I thought it was more like
$700. $700?
Yeah.
Oh, you know what? Yes, you're absolutely right.
It's fucking Braithwaite. Also, you gotta keep on top of them.
You had some money as well, didn't you?
Yes.
Yeah, withdraw.
Okay. Mine was exactly $570.
What, $570?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. All right. She's nice enough, but I don't trust the Braithwaites. Especially with Eddie being at odds with us.
Fair enough.
I need to buy some steaks. Some skirt steaks!
Oh, you can just give mine to him too.
Alright.
Yeah, that way if I'm robbed, it's all gone.
Mm-hmm. So I think that should be 1270, right?
Yes.
Something like that. I appreciate you holding on to this for us.
Oh, of course.
Thank you, Amy. I'm gonna buy some steaks. I'll come back up to the saloon in a minute.
Hey.
Oh, I refilled your boxes with more soup and seasoned steaks because the ones you had in there were not seasoned.
Well, that sounds fantastic. I need that in my life right now.
Oh, yes, just let me know if you run out of soup.
All right. Well, hopefully Harry comes around at some point today so I can offload this money. Fuck. Fuck! How's everyone doing, by the way? Is everyone well? She was impressed that the steaks weren't seasoned. Yeah, well, she's a Braithwaite, man. What do you expect? Pay Raven? Yeah, I gotta pay everybody, man. Everyone deserves to be paid. Well, everyone in DEG gets paid because everyone has access... Well, they should have access to the group funds. However, people that aren't in the gang, like Mo, who's not with us really, and Raven need to get paid separate. Who's that?
Howdy.
Who's that?
Oh my god, did you get stuck?
Who's
my
that?
Sister came to visit.
Oh, I did, Mister. Right, Adelaide, over here.
I'll be right back, sister. All right.
I thought I told you that she's a bad influence and she shouldn't be around you.
I know, but I can't ignore her. Or she'll know I'm ignoring her and she'll come.
That's Dolan.
And she'll get mad.
Get over here. You understand, last time that she came around here, you get all fucking flustered, you get confused and distracted, and you don't work as hard.
I know.
And remember, she probably snitched on your husband.
You're right. She probably did. Told the law he was there at the slaughterhouse.
That's right.
What do I do?
We gotta kick her out, that's what we gotta do.
How?
Where's my security? Where's Pete?
I have no idea.
All right. Go get Scout and Dakota. Tell them to come back here for a moment.
All right.
That's a lie.
How do I get down from up here?
Jump onto the stairs.
Yes, Adelaide. Oh, there we are. Oh, my ass.
Adelaide, what are you doing?
More like a
hey,
dolling.
Hey, what are you doing back here? This is for employees only.
Okay, fine. Watch out, then.
That's right.
Is that all you have?
No. What are you doing? Off the floor.
Thank you.
No. No. All right.
I thought I'd chance my arm, you know? I'm going to break your arm unless you chance it.
Too talkative.
He gave me a chunk of coal.
Man, that's what he gave me yesterday.
I need you to be the bad guys for me.
Okay, I'm good at that.
Perfect. I need you to kick out Addison.
All right.
Hey.
Howdy. Take Peaches with Christ. Peaches. You want to kick out Addison for with Dakota for me?
Well, okay. I'm helping a customer. He's looking for a quiet dancer.
Lovely. I'll do that, and you kick out Addison.
Wait, you're gonna.
Okay. What?
You're gonna dance?
What? I'm gonna get Adelaide.
Is there a reason we're kicking her out? Like,
okay.
to give to her?
She is a bad, terrible influence, and she's a terrible person. And get rid of her.
Okay.
Okay.
yeah, well, some of it went down the wrong way, but it was...
All right, who's the one that wants a dance?
Hi, Addison. I have something to say.
That will be me.
All right, fella. We have two packages. We got the standard dance, which will cost $50. Or you can have the brand new bounce. What time is it? Dance cost $75.
New invention. Here, but whatever.
What I need is a dancer that don't talk.
Oh yeah, we can. That's right. I remember. Well, do you want the time is it, or do you want the standard package?
Perfectly fine.
Well, if there's something new, I want to see it.
All right, $75, sir.
Why do we do that?
Oh, perfect. Kind of mean. I'll make okay. Upstairs, there's a little booth there. Have a seat there, and I'll bring the lady up to you.
Make sure she keep her mouth shut.
Oh, yeah, she won't talk. I assure you that. Oh god, it's the creeper!
Jesus!
Fuck, it's the creepy fella. Alright. Where's Adelaide?
I don't know, we were just looking for her.
Fuck.
Oh, she's upstairs.
Alright, hold on. Upstairs. Adelaide! Yeah, go into the bathroom. Into the bathroom.
Alright.
Right here, sir. Right here. This booth right here. This is for you. There you go. Have a seat. We'll be right with you. Oh. All right. Okay. All right. Sorry, nipples. All right. Now, listen to me. I got a fella out there that requires your services. You're going to give him... What time is it? However, he's paying for you not to speak.
Really?
He just wants you to stand there and bounce.
All right, but the what time is it? I can't do that for very long.
Well, then just make something up. I don't go, fuck, he's a weird fella. He's a creepy fella. Just move around a little bit. Jiggle about. I don't fucking care. Just don't speak to him.
All right.
Period. You don't speak. All right?
No speaking.
That's right. Now, but listen. He is a bit of a creep. If he touches you at all, you let me know, all right?
I will.
I'll fuck up his world. I don't care if he's a deputy.
He's a deputy?
Yeah. Yeah, he's a creepy fucking deputy. Pardon me, fella. Alright, deputy. Got your lovely lady here. And she's gonna perform for you. And, have a fun time.
Alright.
All right, Adelaide, do your thing. Go ahead. There you go. Oh my god, he's making like sounds. Oh god. Oh, God.
I asked for one fucking thing.
Listen, she's not gonna... Listen, my apologies. Can she was talking speak? To me. No, don't talk. She was talking to me, sir. She wasn't talking to you. It's fine. Have a seat. I'll get you a free drink, all right?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right. Don't make a fucking sound. You hear me? Keep bouncing. Can we get a whiskey up here? Yep. Oh, no. All right, listen. This fucking creeper. Adelaide spoke one word and he got fucking pissed. He was gonna fucking leave. So get him a drink and make him happy. Don't speak to him. Just hand him the fucking
okay,
drink.
Okay, should I just crawl on
just,
all fours?
No, don't crawl. Just walk over there and hand the fucking drink and then walk away.
Okay.
Hold on, that doesn't sound good.
This is so fucked, man. This is so fucked. I can't. This is, I know this is going to end, man. This is going to end at some point. He's going to come here and I'm going to have to beat the fuck out of this guy and get arrested. That's what's going to happen. Oh, fuck, Meg. Just go. Just go. Go, 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 go. Shut up. Shut up. Oh. Shut up. Oh god, oh fuck.
It's for her auntie.
Listen, she didn't say nothing, she made a sound.
Yeah. I've had about enough of this one too.
Adelaide, no.
Where's
no, 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 Adelaide, Adelaide. Hold on, hold on.
Where's my fucking tip?
Get off. I'm so sorry, sir. I'm sorry. Listen, it's not a problem. We don't have to make a big deal about this, all right?
Tip. Fucking tip. I'll give you a fucking tip. Keep your mouth shut next time.
Hey. Don't need to be an asshole about it, all right?
Yeah, don't need to be an asshole.
Have a nice day. Thank you for coming.
Yeah, listen. Next time, there won't be nothing like that, all right? You'll get your silent treatment.
Get it!
Fuck! All right.
Wait, no. We want him to come back.
Adelaide. Listen,
kind of
deputy.
What fucking business is this, huh?
Deputy, listen.
Get out!
What are you doing? He's already out. He's already out. Adelaide, go back to the porch. Back to the porch.
Yeah, come on, Adelaide. Let me talk to you.
It's not worth.
I want that
not...
hat back.
Yeah, I'll get you a hat back, all right?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Here's his hat. Sorry, it was a free hat. Here, I'll give you...
Adelaide, he paid $100.
Thank you.
Oh, did he?
Yes, he paid $100. He paid extra.
Why was he so rude?
Because he likes that kind of thing. He pays extra for silence. He's our best paying customer. Oh. Go down there and apologize.
I will dance for you again without any words. I said I did. Without any words.
It's already ruined.
Wait, let me make it right.
How you reckon you're gonna do that? You got a time machine.
I'll make it right. New experience.
You're spoiled now. I'm gonna need a new dancer next time.
What?
I tell you what. We can make it up to you, alright? Next time you come around, 50% discount, alright?
60%.
55%.
How about you shove
deal.
This 60%?
All right, all right, all right. Get back inside. Get back inside. All right, 55%. Is that a deal?
Yeah.
All right, we'll see you next time. Get inside. Get oh, fuck inside. What are you doing?
Leave him alone.
Why are you barking like a chihuahua?
I just want a map.
He's already out.
What?
You know that he's a deputy. He could go down there, write some kind of bullshit charge for assault of a deputy. And you're gone, not making no fucking money. You understand that?
I know. It's just he was so rude.
Yeah, I know he was rude, but he was paying to be rude. That's a fucking difference.
Why don't you tell me that next time?
Because money's not your concern.
I would like to know what
you made your husband in charge of all that.
I did?
Yes, that's what was said. It was an arrangement with your husband, remember?
Uh-huh.
Remember you said Tommy's always right?
He is.
Well, Tommy doesn't want you involved in any of the finances.
I still need to know why I'm doing things for the customers.
All right, well, he pays extra, and he just wants no talk. He's a fucking weird fella. He's a creep.
Oh. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to ruin it.
That's fine, I'm sure he'll come back. He's one of those people. He's not gonna be able to not scratch that itch. You know what I mean?
Right.
We'll just make sure that we get someone that can actually stay quiet to dance.
Should he be a deputy? I mean, that is some weird shit.
Yeah, well, he's a lawman. Yeah, he's a fucking lawman. I mean, technically, it's not illegal what he's doing.
Yeah, it's not illegal to be a creep.
It's just disturbing.
Yeah, well, yeah. You don't want to be arrested by him, okay?
I think the best job for him. Although we are running out of dancers because he said he didn't like Dakota. And what? I don't think...
Oh, we have a habit of hiring really loud mouths.
I did my best.
Yeah, all right. All right, go a little. You got to powder your nose a little bit. And,
Hi, Harry.
Yeah, it'll be fine, all right? I'll make sure next time it doesn't go like that again, all right?
All right, I'll powder my nose and get ready for the next customer.
Yep, that's right. I was definitely doing that.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Harry, perfect.
You hear what I said?
Nope. What'd you say?
Scout was watching me sleep.
Scout was watching you sleep.
Well, listen, all right. It was just temporary. And I was thinking about something, and I walked in the room, and she was there. I tried to be real quiet about it, all right?
You're not making it any better.
Listen, I know that things aren't.
I don't want to. Things aren't going well. You better watch yourself.
But could you not watch ladies sleep?
That award has looked after me fine, thank you, love.
What do you take me for?
Someone that's watching a lady sleep.
No, I'm playing the morning.
Were you just standing there watching? Was he doing anything? Was he just standing there?
Listen, when I was thinking, it might have looked like that.
Yeah, it was weird. But that's okay. Wallaby doesn't give me as much attention as I'd like.
That's
so it's welcome.
I'm giving. All right then.
Okay. Speaking
of
mind,
I have money for you for the expenses of the business. Come on.
Yeah, it's good. I mean,
now you put this down into your little journal.
Yeah, but you were back and far traveling all over, you know, for the last while. You know, settling back into sort of things again in a town, and it's different, you know?
That's a lot of steak.
It is, split up into different things, I don't fucking care. Do, Wagyu or something, I don't know.
Yeah.
Hey, look who it is, huh? Fancy seeing you here.
Me, do you mean?
That's right.
I'm always here, aren't I?
I know that, but I'm just saying, fancy seeing you here again.
Oh, no, it's always good to come by.
Of course. Could I tempt you in the brand new experience that we've discovered?
Is it your dancing, is it?
Well, it's a new dance that no one knew about, but now we have invented it, and it's going to blow people away, and you can get it.
Didn't you discover it?
Yes, we discovered it.
We've been pioneering.
Oh, very good. I assume it's been bringing by good business, I take then, yes?
Oh, yes, it's been doing well, but only a couple gentlemen have seen it. You could be one of the first.
I'm no man for taking dances of women.
Yeah, funny that. Don't want to, give money to hard-working ladies, I understand.
We all have to work hard for our money. But everyone likes giving it to us. Isn't that the way?
Yeah. I understand. Not a problem. Sorry to hear that.
As am I.
Fucking cheapskate. By the way, speaking of which, when are you going to fucking get a dance?
I just did.
Oh, did you pay?
I did.
Who'd you pay?
Adelaide.
What'd you give her?
Thank you.
I felt bad because I didn't give her a tip.
Right.
And I don't want her choking me out, so I gave her $10 so she'd feel kind of better, and then she started dancing. I didn't really want her to.
Very, very kind.
You got a $10 dance.
It was like maybe a minute long. Maybe.
How have you been?
Mm-hmm. Unbelievable, man. Unbelievable. Where the fuck did she go? What's wrong with you?
I'm just taking some time. That's all.
I like the green sweater on you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Put her in a room by herself. She'll talk the paint off the wall.
She's fucking gone, man.
Yep. She.
That's Eddie's cardigan. I know.
Herself.
Who, by the way, that cardigan belongs to Wallaby, because Eddie took it from Wallaby's clothes. Little cannon there for you. Eddie took it from Wallaby, and then she took it from Eddie. Is Wallaby's favorite color green? No. Fucking deputy man, I swear to God. So funny.
So business is booming.
I have no idea where the hell she went, man. I think she went to cash the money so I couldn't fucking take it. She's in here, I swear to God. Oh. Nope. Where the fuck did Adelaide go, man?
Listen, you need to do something.
About what?
There's a particularly crazy...
What's wrong with your voice?
Dog in this town.
You don't sound like yourself.
I do sound like myself.
Yeah, what's the problem?
There's a particularly crazy dog in this town, don't you?
Rennie!
Haven't you heard it?
What are you doing? Good to see ya.
Nice to see you too.
Yeah, are you working today?
Maybe.
Why would you kick me? Because I'm just gonna do this now.
It was well deserved.
What are you doing? What's going on? There's no bank job today, so why are you here?
Why else would I be here?
Because you love me.
Depending on the day.
Yeah, all right. Well, we're up at the saloon, so if you want to get up there, but you're gonna have to get dressed and
No. Look. Just in what? Like in the uniform?
That's right. We're a team.
Right. I'm not wearing a dress.
I didn't say to wear a dress.
Okay, just letting you know.
And what's wrong with a dress anyway? What?
I don't like...
Too good for it, eh?
Absolutely.
Hey, what if I was a woman? I wouldn't mind wearing a dress.
Why?
It feels like it'd be very breezy, very nice and cool.
Well, it is. But have you ever tried to ride a dress and... Ride a horse and wear a dress?
Well, that's why you ride side saddle, my dear.
You ride side saddle and see how stable you are on a horse.
Whatever the fuck.
You fall right off when you start going fast.
You're losing control. They come to you with the most minor problems.
Dog that's in town?
What about it? What was I meant to do about it? What do you want to know about it?
I feel like every time you cage the dog up, it just throws itself against the walls like a crazy fucking... I don't know. I don't know what.
Well, that's the town's problem.
I've never seen an animal throw a temper tantrum like this dog.
Well, I'll talk to the mayor or something. I ain't the mayor, alright? I'm not a politician.
Maybe you should be the mayor.
There she is.
Adelaide, run.
Adelaide?
She's emotional.
Shit, no.
Adelaide, come to the back room. We're gonna have a little chat.
I'm the worst sister in the world.
Well, no, that's not true. There's someone named Addison. That's far worse. Come here. Come with me.
All right.
He has a point.
Hey, howdy. Wait, is that Rennie?
Hi there.
Howdy.
Howdy. Also, we
have all right. Tell me what's wrong.
I feel bad.
About what?
My sister.
Alright, what about her?
Everybody making me feel bad. Because she's gone. They kicked her out.
Yeah, you talk a lot.
I don't know how I feel now.
You could do that without a tongue.
Well, let me tell you something.
I'd like to see you try.
I've known you for a little while now, and I gotta be honest with you. Your sister's a bit of a... Well, she's not a great influence, as we've established.
Right, but...
No. People don't know her the way that you and I do, right? They're gonna make you feel bad, but she is a fucking snitch.
Wanna say it again?
Right.
She called you a cow.
She did.
She wants you to fail at your work. She wants you to rely and depend on her.
Right.
That's right.
She did.
That's right.
She did snitch on my husband.
That's right, she did.
And try to sleep with him.
That's right. She tried to marry him.
I'm fine.
That bitch.
That's right. Now we got that out of the way. You owe me $10. Mm-hmm.
All right.
We try to give a fucking private answer $10. What are you doing?
I did what now? Oh.
Someone paid you $10. You dance for him. What are you doing?
I'm penny pinching.
No, we're not penny pinching here. We are a high quality establishment. If you're gonna dance for that fella, you make sure it's $50.
You're not penny pinching. I'm penny pinching.
You gave a dance for $10. That is not good.
I don't mean to interrupt, but Rennie just beat the shit out of Harry.
Why?
I
think I'll I'm a beat her ass again.
She hit like a bitch or
I mean.
Why?
The one.
Why?
The other one did, yeah. She.
Rennie, no!
Felt what did she say?
Kinda.
Oh, Rennie's here. Like she only comes around when she wants. I'm sure she won't be here tomorrow. So you're still wearing that same.
It was like a push
fit.
Of a hit, kinda.
Alright, first of all.
She's not wrong.
That doesn't give you like to fucking beat her up in the bar here. And second of all...
She was asking for it.
All right, Rennie, come here. We're going to talk, Daniel.
Yeah, go talk to Wallaby, Rennie.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Max, save your ass.
Bad girl. Nice.
What are you doing? What are you doing? Come here.
What do you mean?
Why? Why? You're here for 2 minutes and you got to beat someone up. Why?
I have little patience.
Well, maybe you should get some fucking patience because she's holding about $15,000 of our fucking money.
You...
That's right. Well, maybe you know that if you were around,
you fucking
know.
Didn't.
Yeah, yeah.
No, you didn't.
I did. She works hard around here, all right. When it comes to people that aren't in trouble with the law, she's one of the only ones I know. She seems to care somewhat about this group, so she's holding
somewhat.
The money. Yes, she is.
She cares, but she complains.
Well, so do you.
When's the last time I fucking complained?
About 3 minutes ago. I'm not getting dressed. I'm not working. Kick me in the fucking face.
First of all, I didn't complain, all right? I just said I wasn't wearing a dress. Did not mean I wasn't going to dress, you know, regardless of the uniform and work. Here I am, right?
You're in the wrong uniform.
That's besides the fucking point. I'm not the one fucking complaining.
Listen.
You know what?
You're complaining right now. You're complaining right now.
No,
you're complaining right now.
No, I'm not going to play. I don't even care. You can trust who, you know, put your money trust on whoever. I'm not giving her my cut. I don't trust her. I don't trust barely anyone, honestly.
Well,
I trust the very few people, in this game.
That's a shame that you're saying that because how will we manage without your one cut a year?
Shut up.
All right. You want to fucking start? You want to fucking start? We'll go.
Choke her ass.
Choke her ass.
Choke my ass.
Don't do that.
All right, listen. Just calm down, all right? Harry is, she's with us,
no.
All right? She's friendly.
No.
All right, stop. No more beating up in the saloon, okay? We are together. All right, we gotta make sure this looks legitimate and all that. We can't be fucking around. All right.
Well, tell her to watch her mouth around me.
Just calm yourself, all right?
I am
not
calm.
Not every fucking incident has to end in
people's
bloodshed,
mouths
for fuck's
gets
sake.
Them fucking in trouble, Wallaby.
What?
I said people's mouths sometimes gets them in trouble.
I
as
know.
As long as she's
I
watched
remember,
her mouth around me, then we won't
Adelaide
have a fucking
beat
problem.
The shit out of you because of the same situation, because shit always has to escalate. We gotta stop. Are we not people? Huh?
No, we're animals.
No, what? No, we're not.
And peoples are animals.
Peoples are...
We're mammals.
Point is, you didn't have to beat her up. You know you didn't have to do that.
I did.
No, you fucking didn't because
I
you...
I did.
Why?
Like I said, I have little...
ego.
You're not having a fucking ego.
Ego!
Can I sew her lips shut?
I wouldn't... Didn't she beat you up last time?
No, she... First of all, she choked me out!
I remember.
And I'll do it again!
Adelaide,
okay, alright, this is not helping, alright? Point is, it doesn't have to end in someone getting hurt. Alright?
It's unfortunate Eddie missed her fucking heart. But I'll be on my best fucking behavior.
I'm not asking you to be on your best behavior. I'm asking you to be more, you know, understanding of the situation at hand. Harry puts in work and she's got a lot of paperwork on us and money, all right? We cannot be fucking around with that. It's not worth it.
Whatever I earned in the future, I won't be giving it to her.
So what's that? You're by yourself now.
No, I'm just not putting my funds.
And where are you putting it?
In the, I'm keeping it.
Right, so you're not with us then.
I am with you.
No, because but I'm everyone not... has access to that money. It's the group's money.
Wait, where are you keeping it? Do you have like a sock that's like as big as?
Maybe peaches. Maybe I do have a
are
sock. Is that a problem?
Are you keeping your panties?
I mean, none of us got a bank that we can. You know, I don't know. I'll them bank tellers, do they service you? How many times we rob them?
Oh.
Where are you keeping this money?
Why does it matter?
Butter
well,
guys.
Honestly.
This guy's just still standing here. Let's go see what Harry's doing. How's she doing?
I'm doing fine. Don't worry. I'm not too worried about it. She won't be here tomorrow.
Oh, all right. Just don't.
Well, I can make this worse.
All right, everyone inside. Let's not make it worse, please, for love of God.
Uh-huh.
Do you remember? I heard that conversation between you and her.
Oh, boy.
Jesus Christ.
Y'all not gonna make me feel bad about my sister. She told on my husband.
Do you mind if I sit here for a moment?
That's right.
You, Mick?
That's right.
She told on your husband?
Daddy's
that's right.
You care if I sit
they're going, aren't they? They're going for a little private chat where they're complaining about me, aren't they? Here we go.
You know what she wants, and also, Hody.
Yeah. Everything all right?
Yeah, just... Talking.
Everything's fine.
You know, I'm getting real sick and tired of you saying things are fine when they're not.
They're fine, really.
Oh,
I'm
okay.
Here, am I? I'm working. I'm going to put in the effort. I'm going to do what you tell me to do. I'm going to fall fucking in line.
Fall in line? What are you fucking talking about?
What do
We're
you mean?
We're a team, Rennie.
I get
We're
that. I'm being a team player.
Well,
is that not what you want?
I would like it if you got dressed and maybe dressed a little bit more like Peaches is dressed here.
Fine, Peaches, can you come with me so
yeah, go.
I can you
okay.
can tell me
go tell her how to dress.
Christ.
Okay.
I'll check my telegrams.
You do that.
God damn it.
Did you just say to suck in your ass? Why your ass?
I like Renny because she stands up for herself. I mean, everyone stands up for themselves, man. What are you talking about? Just in different ways. Like, I got fucking, it's like a juggling act, man. All these different personalities. Everyone responds to different kinds of dialogue. I what? Think of the 17-man raid, dude. How you doing, man? You haven't permitted, have you?
I mean.
Is that you, Wallaby? Because I just sent you a telegram.
Oh, that is me. That's right. Okay. Oh, shit. We can discuss things at the same place.
All right. I can head there now.
Yep. Baby, come back. Where the fuck is Pete, man? Davey, man, where is he? Has he destroyed his schedule again? That's what I feel like he's done. He's completely ruined his schedule, and I'm never going to see him again in my life. It's over, man. It's fucking over. Any of the other DG stream? Yeah, a few of them, but they don't always stream. Rennie streams. Angel Knives, she streams. Peaches, obviously. Minx. Scout and Dakota stream every now and again. Peach streams. Eddie streams. They all stream. Alvin streams. I think they all stream. Just some are more active than others. I went nearly to permit today. Of course he did. Of course he did. Ah, boy, oh boy. I feel, you know what's crazy about this saloon arc? Is that I feel like we're depositing money just as regular, if not more regular, than without the front. We're still doing so much fucking shit. Like, we're depositing thousands daily, still. We're just not getting arrested for it.
I know a lot about feelings, you'd be surprised.
I have a lot of them. Sometimes I cry myself to sleep at night.
Alone?
Yeah.
Oh, Scout.
Just wake me up if
you want. He's doing my
I'm here. I'm just enjoying my food with Mickey.
You're reading, right? Ah. All right, I've got some business to attend to if you want to come along.
Yeah, sure. Why not?
Mm-hmm. I better be full of tears, though, because she's crying.
Let me,
We'll fucking stuff it down. Let's go.
I'm coming.
All right, all right.
Wait.
We'll be back in 5 minutes.
Oh, of course, all of right. course. Thank you.
We'll be back.
I think.
Do I need a change?
No.
Okay.
It's your horse. Fucking fence! Jeez. Alright, this way. I love how that lawman didn't come back and arrest us for assault. Some people would have definitely charged us for assault then and thrown us to Sissica.
So, what's on the agenda?
Alright, we got deal with the moonshine fella.
Uh-huh.
You were there last time, right? Or no?
Yes.
Yeah, so we're buying the crate for 125, and then we'll have someone deliver it and make some profit, a little bit of money.
Gotcha. Okay.
Trying to think who we send to do it.
Well, Pete's not around, unfortunately.
No, he's not.
Alvin, I have not seen either. He might be around soon.
Rennie might be a good one to do since she's,
wanting to kill everything?
Yeah. She's got a lot of aggravation in her.
We're gonna hear about 6 dead deputies. If it goes wrong.
Surely she can get that right, right? Riding is her forte, after all. Whose horse
is
that?
Yes, of course.
Whose horse is this?
I would guess that fella standing in the middle of the fields.
Right, all right.
Baby, come back.
I don't know who to give this to. You know, I'm starting to see the strategy behind this. Saw a moonshiner the other day trying to get away from the law, and they fucking blew him up. He was on fire. I guess they're cracking down.
Exactly why I'm coming to you. I sell it for cheaper, but I don't get the law on me.
Smart. Smart. Scott, can you check the quality, though?
I have 10 more absolutely. In my pocket that wouldn't fit in the box.
What'd you say?
I said I have 10 more in my pocket, my satchel. That wouldn't fit in the box.
I see. How much you sell them for?
I'll sell it for a little cheaper than last time, 125. So that way, whatever you decide to do with it, at least you're going to make a profit off of it.
How much did we buy it for last time? 150?
I didn't take it because of... Yeah, it was 150 last time.
Yeah, I remember.
All good?
All good? 125, that's a deal.
All right. Who do you want me to give the extra 10 to?
Scout.
All right.
Oh, you can give it to me, actually. That's fine. I'll give you the money. Scout, grab the box.
Yep.
There you are.
Yeah. That way, if you sell it at the saloon or you want to do the shipment yourself, you at least should be making a profit off it. And the extra 10 there, I only gave you 40 last time. The extra 10 should be enough to do a shipment if you want to. If you want to deliver it to a speakeasy.
That's exactly what we want. We want enough every time to do a delivery.
All right. And selling it at 125, you'll be making a profit, where if you did that last time, you just broke even.
Right.
You get 300, right?
Yes. So, very good. We'll continue this business. I like it.
All right. I'll keep it up. I'll start working on another batch in a day or so.
Lovely. Be in touch.
All right. Have a nice day.
You too. What I'm hoping that the Lord do, and it's probably not going to happen, but I hope it does. I really hope they investigate the saloon.
All good.
Like, over a long period of time. Yeah, we're good. And, like, build up a case of, like, all the illegal shit that we do.
So what's Rennie beating up Harry for?
Because Harry said she won't be here tomorrow. You know how Rennie is. She's got a chip on her shoulder. She's got... You know, she's always the butt of the joke, I suppose. I guess you know how that feels, right?
Oh, yeah, I know how that feels, but I don't fucking beat up Harry over it.
Well, that's the thing, is that she doesn't want to beat up any of us, so she's taking out on Harry. Yeah, I
take it out on fucking Peter Rockwell and homeless people.
Yeah, that's why you're so wise. Maybe you should talk to her.
Yeah, maybe.
Wallaby said worse? Oh, for sure. Yeah, so I'm hoping they do an investigation, like, build a case of... Instead of just arresting us every time they got us for a crime, like, build a case. And then one day, just do a massive raid. Like, smash through the front and back door of the saloon and be like, this is a raid! And, like, get us all lined up. Like, RP searching the place, and I'll give them illegal shit in there. Like, I'll be like, /me, you find stolen bonds. Shit like that. Like, do a big raid. That'd be sick.
I've noticed we haven't heard anything back on the guns yet.
Which ones?
You know, elephant rifle.
Oh, right. No, we should probably talk to Law today if we can. Get an update on that. But, you know how the Law are, these sheriffs, they take fucking weeks and weeks to talk about shit.
Yeah. I would know. I was almost at the end of my sentence when they finally gave me the few months off.
Nope. That's how it'd be.
I was never gonna hear back. Like, 20 days worth.
Yeah, they're not gonna get back to us on that until, like, next month. Would be my guess. But if you're committing crimes, they can't just let you go, right? I mean, I suppose not. But I think investigation RP is way more interesting, man. Like, if I was law, I'd love to do more, like, stakeout work. Stakeout. Undercover. Because we're organized crime, man. You wanna arrest someone not just for, like, a few hours. You want to make a big fucking break or, like, a big bust. Like, if I was them, the goal would... If I was them, the goal would be to shut us down, not just arrest us for a crime. Like, the goal should be to shut down the Dead End Saloon. Because it's a front for a major crime organization, right? So the goal should be to shut it down. If they just arrest us for every crime, they're not going to accomplish that. And I know they do... I know they do investigation RP at times. I know they did with the DiCenzos. All right.
Welcome back.
Yeah. How many was it in the box?
40. You need 50 total.
You need 50, right.
Mm-hmm.
Does anybody else see that lady standing over there?
Oh. Yes, I do.
Over where?
Over where? In the blue dress.
Oh.
Wow.
That was really good. That was right around the neck.
There she goes. Thank you, Harry.
Wow.
Rennie.
Can
I have a quick word? You can go around back. So I just got a, box of 50 moonshine. Wondering if you want to deliver or not.
Sure.
Alright. You think you can do it?
Yeah, I could do it.
Alright, it's $300 for delivery, yeah?
It is.
So I'll take 200, you take 100?
Fair.
Alright. We'll go around back and give you the box.
I don't know about you, but today just feels like a day where I just want to be, you know?
Yeah, me too.
Scout.
Me too.
Let's give Rennie the box.
Okay.
He's still fucking eating. Probably best not dress like that when you do this.
Yeah, I wasn't.
It's definitely an outfit for moonshining.
There's a change room in the saloon. All right, here. I gotta give you this first.
Oh, okay.
There's only 40 in there. I got 10 more on me. All right. Good luck.
Thought we were saving it.
For what?
Like when bank jobs happen or something, so that way we have a, you know, higher chance.
I mean, he's gonna make more tomorrow, so.
Fair.
You wanna be hauling around boxes of that shit for days? I don't
know. No. Just a thought was all.
I understand.
Wallaby, I don't know if you got a Peach's telegram, but she was looking for you because the dinner's happening.
Oh, lovely. Where's it happening?
I can show you. It's at their house.
All right. Do I have to dress any certain way, or?
I don't know. Probably not.
All
I'm
right.
Not going to.
All right. Come with me. This is happening now.
Yeah, it seemed like they wanted us to come over now.
Alright. Do me a favor and give the map location a scout in case we don't come back.
Okay, perfect. Good idea.
Yeah.
Okay.
This could be anything, guys.
Hey,
I got no idea what to expect at this dinner. Could be nothing, could be friendly, could be a goddamn trap. Who knows?
In case we're not back, Wobby and I are... Oh, headache!
Yeah.
Wobby and I are going to that dinner.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's just gonna be us in case we're not back. It is the house north of Annisburg. Do you know the one that
has that house?
Junk in front of it, and there's like a gate.
I think it's this one here.
The one that's like just to the left of the railroad tracks?
Yes, I believe so.
Oh, this one.
Yeah, it's one that doesn't have a bed in it.
There's a chair and a fireplace and a table.
And then a bunch of junk out front with a little fence all the way around.
Yep.
Okay, how long for you to be gone before we start getting worried?
Right?
Yeah, probably. They said one last talk, so, you know.
Oh, one last talk?
Yeah.
No.
I'm sure we can get out of there, too, if things feel weird.
Yeah.
All right. Are you sure you don't want us around to on the hill or something, just
maybe,
in case?
If you want to move to... I guess you could go to Annisburg, if you like, or Van Horn and wait there.
Yeah, but also, they're pretty old and frail, so...
Yeah, I mean, I'm there, you know?
I trust him.
It's up to you.
Should be fine.
I'll do whatever. Okay. In an hour, if you're not around, then we'll come looking.
Yeah, yeah.
Yep, yep.
All right.
You getting dressed?
Oh, yeah, true.
This is sus, man.
Can I just ride with you?
Of course.
Are you sure? I'm positive. I don't know why I'm so nervous. It's gonna be fine.
Well, it's time to get this over with, right?
Yeah, and then they said, you know, this is all they want, there's nothing else. So I can finally move on.
Perfect.
Thank you for coming with me.
I don't mention it, you do the same thing. Like the Al Swearingen arc, it fits your character. Oh, thank you, man. Yeah, I'm really digging the Deadwood kind of arc we're on right now. Just, if you feel anything, we'd leave, all right?
Yeah. Wait, feel what?
I mean, if you don't feel comfortable, you want to get out of there, you just let me know. We get out.
Okay, I mean, I'm going to feel uncomfortable no matter what, but also... Yeah.
You know what I mean.
I don't know. Yeah. It's really hard because they're right. They did help me a lot when I got hurt. And so I feel guilty that I feel this way about them.
What do you mean? What do you mean you feel guilty?
Well, I mean, they make my insides squirm. Like, I really... I don't know, but also... They look so sick. Especially Gwyneth, and they did take care of me for a while. And for a while, I did have a family, which is what I wanted. Just, I don't know, there were good times, just also bad. And the lion thing, is
you told me that they were like husky.
Yeah, but seeing them, I mean, she's so sick now. Maybe I just made it up in my head, you know? Maybe I just...
Oh my god. Oh, this is...
I don't know.
Oh no, I don't like this.
Maybe I was too harsh on them, is what I'm saying.
Act on your guard. Oh, for sure, but I don't want to be too much on my guard. Because ultimately this is her backstory. Like, can you imagine like the Husky arc, for example? Imagine if we had like Husky was doing what he was doing and then all of a sudden just someone came over and just shot him. You know what I mean? Like, I don't want to fuck up what they're doing, so I'll go along with it.
And be quiet for one moment.
Like, Wallaby will be on his guard, but I'm not gonna like go in there and fan the hammer on him, you know, unless it like leads that in a realistic way. We'll see. I got no idea what's gonna happen. Could be anything that we're running into right now. If Luna's calmed down, apparently she was going fucking crazy. She was going mental.
You know, when I ran away from home, I lived out in the wilderness for a while, and there's actually this waterfall. Do you know where it is, where you can like hide behind? I think it's all the way up north.
Brandywine or something.
Yeah, and it was awful living there. Like, everything got wet. Clothes got all musty. I was never clean, even though, you know, you were with water, but it felt really safe, because, I don't know, it was like that water was like a little shield. And even though I was cold and crusty and all that, it was my home for ages. And it was finally, you know, like freedom. And, after the stuff with Eddie happened too, I hid there. But it was different. I don't know what I'm, it's just weird thinking about this time and how everything's changed, going back and revisiting this house and that waterfall. It's...
Oh, you gotta face your past. We all do. At some point. But don't let it beat you down, though.
Yeah, I ain't the same girl.
That's right. You're not.
It'll be okay.
Of course. As I said, hell.
Yep.
Hey.
Okay. Yeah.
You sure you want to do this?
We can leave. Yeah, I gotta face my past. We can move on after this. This is it.
Alright. Off to you.
Just give me a moment, okay? I don't know why I'm so...
They're just people. When we're kids, we build them up to be something they're not.
Yeah, exactly. I think I must have built them up. It'll be fine. Okay. Let's go.
Why is there a shovel?
Under the awning. Get out of the rain, please. How are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm very well. I hope your travels were not too harsh.
No, this is, Wallaby, by the way. Wallaby Gwyneth.
Wallaby, you say?
Yeah, that's right. They call me the Wallaby Kid.
The Wallaby Kid.
That's right.
Well, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Yeah, you too.
Would you like me to call you Wallaby Kid or just Wallaby?
Wallaby's fine.
All right. Well, it's a pleasure. You can call me Gwyneth if you'd like.
Yeah, all right, Gwyneth.
Do come in. It's a mite bit warmer inside than it is out there. Here. Let me get the door.
Howdy. It's a pleasure to see you again. It's good to see you. You got the flowers. Those weren't here before. I don't think.
Yes, I remember they were your favorites, dear.
Yeah. I'm sorry, I guess I should have brought something, huh? Isn't that like the proper thing
to
do?
No, it's perfectly fine, dear. You're just visiting after all, right?
Yes.
It's all right. Besides, you being here is... Well... More than a gift in and of itself, you know?
That's kind. Where's Earl?
Earl is out fishing for a bit. He grumbled something. He said that he was reading something in one of his almanacs and said, "Today is a good day for fishing, my dear." I said, "But you know who's coming, right?" He grumbled something and, well, you know how he is, right? Once he gets an idea into his head, he stubbornly persists at it.
Yeah.
It's all right. Perhaps we can actually enjoy some of our conversation without him grumbling in the corner.
Yeah.
Oh, forgive me. This is my dear sister, Mr. Wallaby. Sister, introduce yourself.
Aline, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Yeah, you too. So you all, live up here or what?
Oh, I do. My dear sister's visiting, though. Just recently arrived. Do you like this area, Mr. Wallaby?
Can't say I don't, I don't come up here very often. But it beats the West, I suppose.
I've always found out West a bit too dusty for my tastes, I must admit. All of the dirt, sand. It's unpleasant, in my opinion. I like the air out here. It's clear and crisp. At least you can tell when it's going to rain.
Right, yeah. Yeah, that is true.
Let me make sure the stew is ready. Please, make yourselves at home.
Yeah. Where do you want to sit?
I don't know. I guess I'll sit here.
Sure.
Oh, no. You sit at the head. I'll sit here.
Right. All right.
So, Mr. Wallaby, what is it that you do for a living, dear?
I run a fine establishment out of Rhodes.
Oh.
Yeah. Saloon. Dead End Saloon. Stop by sometime. We have, wonderful food and dancing girls. And cards. And booze.
That's
that sounds like a lively establishment, then.
Oh, it is. Business is booming, they say.
What's it take to run a place like that?
A lot of patience. Yeah. It's like juggling knives.
Work with unsavory people often.
What's that?
Work with unsavory people often.
Well, that's all part of it, right? We are in the crossing, after all.
She chops some chunks of meat up.
When did y'all get back? I was surprised.
I don't
want to
play any music here, man. Just for the vibe. I think the quiet makes it more sinister. This particular moment.
Well, Earl and I managed to get back here, home. Probably about a month and a half, 2 months ago.
Well, surprised I didn't bump into you earlier.
The grumbling from that man when he came to see the state of this place. Ugh. You'd think the world had ended.
So what kind of fish is he catching?
I'm not sure. Sometimes he'll come back with a bass. Sometimes a trout. I suppose it depends on his luck, because... Excuse me. Sometimes he comes back with nothing at all.
Right. And you two are married?
I'd say happily, but I'm sure he'd argue about that.
Oh, for how long?
I think on about 35 years now, actually. 40 now, perhaps.
Oh. You alright?
Sometimes. Gets a bit hard to remember. I think this is coming out nicely. I think we'll let that simmer for a bit. The forgive me if I join you at the table a moment.
Of course, of course.
Ah.
How have you been, feeling?
I've been feeling better of late. I think being back home in the air here, it's helped both me and Earl a bit.
A horse?
How did you get sick? Was it...
I think it was from where we were staying. While we were healing.
Oh yeah? Where was that?
Oh. There was a place, first we went to a doctor in Saint Denis. Then he referred place. Oh, further up the river, I don't remember the name exactly of the hospital, but they were very kind.
I am sorry about that.
It's all right, dear. Oh dear, I think our friendly neighbor is back again. Oh, it sure is.
Do you need me to get it?
If any of you feel capable of
fighting
this four-legged friend, be careful.
Yeah, not a problem. Oh shit, it's a fucking cougar. Fucking. Ouch.
You okay?
Just a scratch, I'm fine.
You can look at it if you want.
No, it's fine. It's fine. It's embarrassing. Dude, I was about to shoot, but I got caught in animation.
Forgot I didn't have bullets.
Yeah, I
Are
just
you
used
all right,
that. Yeah, just a scratch. Where do you want it?
Oh, just go ahead and place it on the porch there. I'll deal with it later.
Yeah. It's mostly his blood, it's fine.
Hmm? Oh, that's dead.
Anyone have any? That's not
Is that another one.
One? Yeah, give me a second.
Yeah.
Now, this one I've got to be careful of. Kitty, kitty, kitty. Where? Shit, rock. I'll get the heart going.
But you're right.
Yeah, he ran off. Where'd he go? Where did he go? I'm running the shotgun shells. I think he retreated. I think he's gone. I hit with a nice navy shot. Yeah, I think he's fucked off. I think we're good. That took hits. Must be one shot. Yeah, the first cougar took one shotgun blast and he was fucking gone. I hit him with, I think, two shots with a shotgun. They might have grazed him, but I hit him with the navy as well, at least a couple times. So he'd be fucked up. Yeah, I think he ran away. I heard it pretty bad.
All right.
Sorry about that. You shouldn't have any problems anymore.
Appreciate it.
Maybe you should check on that Earl fella.
I'm sure Earl is fine.
Yeah.
If you need any bandages or medical supplies, we have some in the back. I can grab it.
Thank you for dealing with our lovely little neighbors.
Yeah, not a problem. Mm. He ran away into the shrubbery. He should be gone.
He tends to do that sometimes. Scared off, likely. I think a little extra treat.
Yeah, extra treat sounds good.
Have you ever had cougar before?
Well, you know, one time I was on the rod and we had to eat some cougar, yeah.
There's some particularly fine meat once you remove some of the leaner bits. Here we are. So please, tell me about some of your interesting customers at your establishment. Or any fun stories that you've had of late?
Well, we have one fella that pays well, but he doesn't like when the ladies talk to him.
Yeah, he's real weird.
That's quite curious.
He just sits in the corner and watches. It's very bizarre, but, you know, money's money, right? Sure, you know all about that.
Can't complain, right?
No, not at all.
Well, I'm sure that sort of thing brings its own share of excitement.
No, I live a quite a boring life. I, just run the saloon, you know, sell alcohol and such.
Well, it takes a lot of work to run a saloon.
Yeah,
you must have some sort of business acumen.
That's a living, I suppose.
That's very true.
Trying to provide for me and Irene here. Yeah, I'm looking after her.
Well, that's good. Thank you for looking after her.
Yeah, you're welcome. I've heard the stories about you looking after her.
Yes. Yes. That's to be expected, though. Family and such.
I think they're just different but harmless. I got no idea yet.
Well, while we wait for the rest of that to cook a bit more thoroughly. So you say Rhodes. What made you choose Rhodes of all places?
Well, it's where I grew up, pretty much. I came over here as a teenager, and people of Rhodes there kind of looked after me a little bit. Irene was there for all that.
Yeah, that's, actually where I met Corvus. So.
Fuck, is it raining outside? That sounds like it's heavy for me, man.
I like it there.
Yeah, it's become like a home to us.
I see. That's good. I'm sorry to make you come all this way. It's quite a ride from Rhodes out to here.
That's all right. It weren't no trouble.
You both look very nice, by the way.
Thank you.
That blouse is very fetching on you, dear.
Oh, that's kind of you to say. I'm trying out something new, actually, and so...
I always make sure she's got a shirt underneath it. The girls nowadays, they just wear the corset and they just let everything hang out, but I've, you know, made sure that she's... that we're both proper.
Truly? Is that some sort of modern fashion sense?
Well, you know, we got some girls that show quite a bit of ankle down at the saloon, but Irene, she doesn't get into all that.
Oh, dear. Wearing nothing but a corset is scandalous.
Yeah, it is a little bit, but, you know.
As an accessory for what you're wearing with it right now, dear, I think it looks quite nice. It's tasteful almost, but just a corset. My goodness.
Yeah, that'd be, scandalous.
Scantily clad, of course.
Yeah.
Must get quite cold, I would imagine. Dear me. See, back in my day, years ago, should you even shown just a hint of skin around your wrist or ankle, the whole town would speak about it for weeks to come.
Well, I don't know why it would be any of their business, you know?
This is
that's
the crash
what
event.
I would say. What's a little bit of public flirting, showing an ankle or two, right, dear?
That's right. Yep. I've seen a lot of ankle.
Hmm.
Or for work, you know.
Of course, business ankle.
Not Irene's ankles or nothing like that, you know, waiting for, you know, something. You know, if she...
Yes, something.
Yeah.
Hmm. Right, of course. A business ankle is a bit different.
Yeah, business ankle, personal ankle, two different things. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I've never seen Irene's ankle is what I'm trying to say.
Really?
Yeah, that's right. Yes, ma'am.
And you two are together?
Yes. Yeah, well...
And
you know.
You've never seen her ankle?
Well, you know, she's a respectable woman, right?
Dear.
Yes?
I know I raised you to be a bit, cautious, but, you know, it's all right to, show a little ankle every now and then to, those you care about, you know?
Yeah, of course, in due time.
Of course, when you're ready, dear, I know that's a big step.
Yeah.
Wait, am I gonna see ankle tonight?
Well, maybe.
Well, lovely, let's get this stew underway.
Dear.
Yeah, what about that?
And where's
thing?
Earl with the fish? Is she whispering?
Gwyneth? Bobby, can you hear me?
Oh, yeah, I can hear you.
Mm.
So I think she's just staring at me.
Oh.
And so, are we cooking the fish? I mean, I'm not really much of a fish eater, if you ask me. But, you know, I would enjoy the stew. Hey, what's your name again?
Hmm? Mine.
Yeah.
Eileen.
So, whereabouts is Earl fishing?
I honestly haven't a clue. I don't pay much attention to that old man. He gets on my nerves.
All right. I could go get him if you like.
Might be best you not come. He's a habit of putting a damper on things.
Oh, yeah, we want to kill the mood that's going on in here.
Yeah, he can be a little cranky. A little is a bit of an understatement. I've never met a man so displeased with the world. Yeah,
I know
things
one.
Upset him. What did you say, Wobby?
I said, I think we know one.
That's true. We do know. I think. Yeah, you know what? That's true. We do have someone like that, but. I think his company's enjoyable. Sometimes.
That fucking cat's back. Hold on.
Is it?
I think so. I kind of want to check around the house, man. The fuck is that? There it is, you piece of shit. Well, how? How? He took it to the face, man. Fuck me. Swear to God, these cougars are getting harder and harder to kill.
What gun is that?
Double barrel.
Oh.
He took it to the face, Irene.
Yeah, I'm telling you, actually, the best way to fight cougars is with a knife.
Well, thank you for that information.
Yeah, you're welcome. Maybe I'll show you one day.
I'm gonna get my coat from my horse. I don't know how there's a third corpse there, but whatever. I'm not gonna ask questions. Oh great, the coat's got blood on it. Fantastic. I'm gonna take this opportunity to check around the house real quick. See if this Earl fella's creeping about. Or if there's any hidden details.
Vert Yoda, Vert Yoda, Vert Yoda.
It's a box. I know, it's not a box you can open. It seems all on the up and up.
Vert Yoda, Vert Yoda, Vert Yoda. Hey, Day Eugene. Thank you for the 3 months, mate.
Man, they got dandelions everywhere.
Ought to be ready.
Oh, fantastic. I'm starving.
Could one of you dears help me with some bowls here?
Yeah, sure.
You don't think Earl's gonna be pissed off we're eating without him, right?
Oh, don't worry. I'll reserve some for Earl. Oh, thank you, dear.
You're all right. It actually looks less horrific with this outfit on, without the coat. Smiles at her, ladling stew into the bowl.
There we go.
There's fucking elk out there.
There's quite a lot of creatures out there.
I suppose so. Yeah, thank you.
An interesting thing living out here. And nature has a way of making itself heard. a lot of the times. Here you are, dear sister.
Thank you.
So do we, like, do you, like, say grace or something?
Would you like to say grace?
Oh, I don't know. I'm just asking if you do that, and it's your home, it's not my home, so.
Sometimes. Although, it's usually Earl whipping out his almanac and sort of talking about what the weather would be like tomorrow.
Yeah.
But if you have any sort of things you like to do?
No, I just usually just dig in.
All right. Then let's go ahead and just enjoy this wonderful dinner together.
Yeah, all right.
Savory herb bowl of stew. Oh my god, my arm. There we go.
That tastes pretty good. Yeah, thank you for this.
Of course. Sort of a blend. It's actually got some elk in it.
Yeah,
that my dear sister hunted. It's got some cougar meat now. And a blend of other savory herbs. Quite delicious.
Yeah, that might be one of the best stews I've ever had.
Good.
Yeah, I definitely miss your cooking.
Good, good. I'm glad to hear that, dear. To be honest, this house hasn't been as lively, but, but it's nice that it has life in it again, you know? Even just this one visit means a lot.
Oh, like I said, I appreciate you all having us for dinner.
Yeah, it's a shame Earl wasn't here. I would like to meet him.
Oh, that crotchety old fool. You'll meet him, I know. He wanders around sometimes. A bit too much, I think, for his health.
You don't think he got lost or nothing, right?
Maybe. He does tend to forget where he is sometimes. But, well, I suppose that's just how things are. He'll make his way home eventually. Oh, that crotchety old fool.
I don't think there's any reason to worry. He'll be all right. Oh, sorry, yeah, I can clear the table.
Oh, thank you, dear. So what have you been doing, dear, as well?
Mostly just working at the Parle House, you know?
You all think we're eating Earl?
Well, that's good. Do you like it there?
I hope we didn't eat Earl.
It's nice. It's a, you know, a nice break.
Nice break?
Oh, you know, just, you know the whole old saying when it's, you enjoy your work, it's like a vacation.
Oh, yes. I know that feeling. Thank you, dear. It's like you never left.
Mm. Oh, they're not too bad, these are. Oh,
it is nice to have you here again.
She's fucking gone.
Where's the husband, Gwyneth?
Sorry, what did you say? I said it's nice to have you here again. Yeah, yeah, it's bringing back a lot of memories.
Are you fuck? Oh. Are you fucking kidding me? It can't be another cougar, man. Oh shit, no ammo!
Oh god, I almost killed
you. Oh! Knife not good. Knife not good. Reload!
What the fuck?
Last time you gave me advice about how to fight a cougar. This is fucking ridiculous. Use a knife, he says, man. Use a knife. Why did we listen to her? Now I've run out of fucking shotgun bullets, damn it.
What are those things made out of these days?
Oh, yeah.
Probably what's ever in the water.
Fucking hell, man. I've just been getting fucked up by cougars all goddamn day.
Good. So worried about you there?
This area sucks.
Wobby.
Of late, they've been more...
Yeah, you think? Look at this.
Active.
Look at that.
I feel like you've wiped out an entire family of cougars today, dear.
I have. I should be paid for this.
You're very formidable.
That's what they say.
I'm one
of the fastest, you know.
One of the fastest?
Yep.
Oh.
One of the fastest going around in the crossing.
Oh, dear.
That's right.
That is impressive.
Yep. You want to see a trick? Watch this. And here we go. A little up in the air, a little behind the back. Yeah, not a problem at all.
Maybe a little bit. I could do that.
My brother taught me how to do this.
I used to do that a lot for my wife's siblings.
His name was Joey.
Always trying to show off some new trick.
Oh, she's having so much problems, but I feel bad.
Not the gunslinging type. I'm not good at that stuff.
I just made your sister very excited.
Well, for guns.
Oh, she saw my trick. My little finger trick. Yeah, you want to see it?
Sure.
All right. And here we go. All right, I'll do the trick. Here we go. And up in the air and catch and wiggle it around. What do you think? What do you think of that? How's that float your boat?
Yeah, how does that float your boat?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, I don't really have a boat that floats, but it's rather interesting. Yep. How long it take you to master it?
Oh, my big brother taught me how to do it when I was just a young little boy in the streets of Sydney. He was the best. But, I practice from time to time.
So, Mr. Wallaby, tell me what you did before you started working in the saloon.
Well, you see, I got a headache. It's cursed, man! The whole house is fucking cursed. Boy, oh boy. It's all good though, man. Let's get back in there.
Let's get some wiggles in the chat, boys and girls. There they are. Alright, I think you guys are hyping off. Alright, let's turn it down a little bit, man. We might have just ate human meat, but we don't know yet. But we're going to find out, I'm sure.
Love what you do with the story with Wallaby. Don't let peaches get turned into stew.
Well, I'm trying, man. Oh, sorry about that.
You're fine.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. Where was I? Oh, yes.
You were showing us.
Yeah, I'll show you my little finger trick. So, what were you asking?
What you did before you opened up your saloon.
Oh, you know, I was a bank robber. Best
Are you
outlaw.
Still one?
No. I'm retired now. I was the best at what I did. But, you know, time catches up to all of us, and I've decided to become legitimate.
Mm. Must have been hard leaving a life like that behind.
Well, you know, it's, I always thought I'd die in my early 20s, but, you know, for some reason, I have something now that I don't want to leave behind.
Well, that's sweet.
Yeah.
I hope Gwen is okay. She must have been really impressed.
Oh yeah, she Julie. She was like, oh. Like that.
Like what?
Oh.
Oh.
Yeah.
Ah. Oh my.
Yeah. I saw a twinkle in her eye.
You better be careful, Wallaby.
Oh, you know.
I want her stealing you.
The old lasses like me.
Uh-huh.
Gwyneth.
So sorry,
recovered from
ideas.
Saying my finger trick, I say.
Oh, it was very, But let's just say I don't think you would have many issues finding someone.
Well, that's right. That's right.
Well. Especially back in my day.
Oh, yeah, of course.
So. My dear.
Yes?
I wanted to ask something.
Okay.
I understand it might be a bit much to ask, but I was wondering if you wanted to spend some more time with myself and Earl and my dear sister. I know it's a lot to ask for, given your work nowadays, but it's been so nice to see you again. It's almost like nothing's changed, you know?
I'm sorry, but I have changed. I really do appreciate your hospitality, but
I have a life now, and well, I'm happy to see you all doing well. I'd like to leave the past behind and continue forward.
Yes, I'm
sorry,
suppose you're
like
right.
I said, I appreciate everything. Just
no,
I don't want to be. I don't want to be that same girl. I don't need need no taken care of. I don't need nothing. I ain't a kid no more.
I suppose there's a moment in every mother's life when this sort of thing must happen, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Leave the nest and all that.
But like I said, I'm grateful. I'm grateful. And I'm sorry for what I did. And,
dear. You have apologized so much for that. As I have said, all is forgiven.
All right.
A lot happens in life sometimes, and sometimes we find ourselves at moments of crossroads almost. Sometimes we find ourselves waking up one day unsure of what the right thing to do is, or the right next step.
Yeah, and I'm sorry it needs to be this way. This time in my life is something
me,
I
man.
Want to leave behind.
That look at me.
You have someone with you now that you can share things, which is good. Like, I have Earl and my sister. You have Wallaby.
Yeah. And I'm happy.
I am happy for you, my dear. But at the same time, this selfish mother of yours is sad. Do forgive me for my selfishness. I know even coming out here is a selfish request of mine that this beautiful daughter has obliged, of which I am so very grateful.
Yeah.
Before you two go, might I interest you in a cup of tea or perhaps coffee? Wash away any fatigue that you might feel after that heavy meal?
I mean, I don't say why not.
Yeah,
I wouldn't mind a coffee.
All right. Wonderful.
You chat.
A coffee.
It's fine,
Your
guys.
Sister, would you help me? There's some grounds up above there. All right. Let me get the kettle here.
Yeah. It doesn't seem that bad, really.
That's what I'm saying, right? I think it was one of those things I must have made it in my head.
That's just rather reasonable, really.
Exactly.
Yeah, I'm just making a cup of coffee. It's beautiful.
Yeah, and I feel bad I said no, but I mean, maybe seeing her every once in a while ain't bad.
Or maybe we, you know what we should do? We should maybe invite her to the horn. I mean, the dead end saloon sometime. Get some food and a drink or something.
Introduce her
to the friends and such. Yeah.
Yeah, and seeing
poor
her
old
every
hag
once in a
is
while,
up here all by her lonesome. She's fucking lonely, you know. You just maybe invite her and get her, you know, be around young people. Maybe it would give
make her
life.
Feel better.
Right, right.
You talk rather loud, darling.
Oh, my apologies.
Yeah, we were just actually.
Did they hear that whole thing?
Maybe, I don't know. I'm not them.
Shit.
We were just talking. Maybe, you know, you could stop by the saloon sometime and, you know, we can show you around.
I have not been to a proper saloon in years.
Yeah, it's really nice. And maybe we can get you a dance and some, you know.
I think I would very much love that.
Yeah.
And you seem a very keen proprietor, Mr. Wallaby.
Yeah, I think you should say exactly what it is we do. I think you'd enjoy yourself.
Perhaps a change of pace is nice, too, every now and again. These sorts of days, knitting away here at home, can be quite boring. Especially as Earl has found himself wandering around more often. You know, he started calling himself a cougar hunter.
Oh, wow.
He's never killed one. But he starts calling himself that because he chases them away.
Yeah, that sounds like him.
Oh, dear. Dear sister, would you like some as well?
I think I'm good.
All right. I'll make a cup for myself, actually.
Caring not for those damn cougars.
Here we are. Oh, I wanted to get something for you, dear.
She opens the cabinet, old boy. Be good, right, chat? It's just a book.
Not sure if you want this, my dear, but I saw it the other day.
That. It's such a pretty flower.
She's glaring at me.
You.
Oh. Not again, man. Oh, man, I feel so bad for him. Oh, fuck. I feel so bad for him, man.
Hope Scout doesn't worry yet.
I think we're gonna be out of here any minute now anyway, so don't worry about it.
Okay.
We'll go down to Arnesburg, send a telegram, not to worry.
Okay.
I'm just assuming it's the air now. I hate this place, I'll tell you.
What, really?
Always hated it.
I didn't know that.
Did they talk about the pot? I saw it before, it's just food.
They just never seem to want to leave here.
Yep, sir.
I think when you live someplace for so long...
I hear Sarah yelling, something's happening.
Like you're abandoning it.
God, she is... Something's happening, man. Over in Rose.
I think if they had the choice, they'd stay here until they die, but... I came here to support my sister. I'm not staying forever.
GGG, Grandma Ghost Cereal.
Oh, really?
Listen, she is fine, man. Gwyneth is a nice old lady.
I've supported her for most of my life.
Obviously.
I'd like to live some of it for my own. Even if just a few years. That makes sense. You said you had a wife as well, right?
Mm-hmm.
Eva, dream of buying a house on a countryside. Always been obsessed with the thought of a farm. Yeah, that'd be nice. You could do that. I'm sure Earl can take care of Gwyneth. Something like that. But until then, Margaret and I are here to do that. Or however long is left. But is she done? She's certainly not getting better. You haven't seen the coughing fits. The wheezing and the hacking and the straining of my sister's breath. But no one can stop. No one can stop the tick of time, so I'm simply trying to make it as enjoyable as possible for her. So have you tried to reach out? You are one of the most important things to her. Like I said, you all can come to the Dead End Saloon whenever you want and come visit. I just this house, it's too. It's hard, you know. I understand. I appreciate you talking to her at all. Yeah, to be honest, I really thought they were gonna be angry for what I did and try to hurt me or something. No, no. And being called Nelly again and seeing those posters, it just spooked me something fierce. But I was telling Wallaby here, I think maybe I might have just, you know, kids have a wild imagination, and maybe I'm misremembering things, you know? Shadows can seem like monsters when you're younger. Nobody holds anything against you. Except maybe Earl a few times he broke a dish, but... I've done the same. Yeah, I used to be so clumsy back then.
And there's a black.
Oh, they're manipulating hard, man.
Cancels out.
Husky did the same fucking shit.
Hope Gwyneth's alright. I'm sure she's just taking a moment to herself. Now tell me, how long have you two been together? If you are officially together.
Oh, I haven't really kept track. A little bit. Funny story, actually. I shot her once.
You're speaking very quiet.
God damn it. I said, you know, it's been a little while, and we've been through quite a bit.
God damn it, speaking too loud, speaking too soft. Oh,
looks like the water's done warming up.
Appreciate the hospitality.
Of course, of course.
Can't Wolby see the manipulation? No, his guard's down. Because she has been rather nice. He doesn't know her. Her manipulation, the manipulation these two are showing are much different than Husky. That's why his hands are behind his back. He feels comfortable. He feels like he's got it under control.
All right, dear. Here we are.
Thank you.
And your coffee, my dear. It'll take just a moment to sort of settle. But feel free to drink it as you will.
Sure. Appreciate it. Oh, boy.
Let's take a seat so we can talk more. Oh, let me get mine.
It's not a tea, man. Oh, no, it's a drug. Oh, no! Oh, no!
Are you ordering sugar?
Oh, yes. Do forgive me one moment.
Of course. Unbelievable. It's like another goddamn cat. You want me to handle that before we drink?
Sure. I think that would be lovely.
Yeah, just a couple of sugars in my cup, that'd be great.
Sure, I've got that, dear.
Where's this fucking cat? There he is. Come on.
You like some tea, dear?
Alright.
Would you like two spoonfuls or one?
Two, please.
Fuck.
Here you are. You truly are one of the fastest, I think, dear.
Thank you.
All right, well, this is, lovely, thank you. Here's
You're
to,
welcome.
I suppose, moving on and creating a new future, right?
That's right.
Yeah.
The new future.
Yes.
I'm excited for it, dear.
Yeah, well, I'll drink to that. Oh.
I hope it's to your taste, dear.
A little sweet.
Oh, did I put too much sugar in there?
You might have put a little. What kind of sugar you put in there?
Hmm? Oh, just normal sugar.
I don't know, sit down.
Here you are.
This is a good idea.
I think seating yourself is good. There you are.
No.
Yeah. Let me get something to help you.
Am I?
It's a strong cup of tea.
Sister.
Hmm.
Might have done a bit much.
Oh?
Oh, is she all right?
Oh, of course, dear. Yes, she's doing rather fine.
Dear, I think I might have put a bit too much sugar in there.
Oh, my.
Oh, where'd you fucking go?
We didn't do anything, sir. Don't overwork yourself.
I think it's best if you relax right now, dear.
Oh, fuck.
I wouldn't suggest that. Come on.
You fucking old hag, you. I should have known that.
Known what, dear?
You're just like him.
Like who?
Husky Tarbox.
There we are. You are a strong young man, aren't you?
And you'll find out.
I'm sure we will. But for now, just relax. There isn't really any point in fighting it. It'll just make everything worse.
If you'd like, you can take this one. It will make you fall asleep a little more. Might make it easier on you, dear.
I can get her going now if you would like.
Yes, please.
No. Come on now. Baby steps.
No.
Come on. I'll meet you there.
Where you going? Oh, you fucking bring her back.
You'll be all right, dear. Maybe one day you'll see her again.
I'll find you.
You might find us, perhaps, but will she ever be the same? She's my daughter. She's mine. I'm her mother. Mr. Wallaby, mother knows best. You ought to know that by now. Rest well, dear. Don't let the cougars bite.
Holy shit.
Well done, man. Well fucking done. Holy shit. Oh, I'm so glad Scout didn't show up in the middle of that. This is far better. Yeah, Wallaby got cocky there, man. He thought he was in control of the situation. He was like impressing them with his gun tricks. They flattered him a little bit and he just fell right into their bullshit, man. Lesser Magic, thank you for the tier 2. 27 month resub.
Well, shit.
Well, shit indeed, man. How good was this ragdoll? I doubt that's what they're gonna see when they get here. But I don't care, at least we got it. At least we got it. It's beautiful. Some high tier ragdoll right there. Fuck, then I'm not seeing Peaches again. I got no idea. I have no idea what is going on. I'm just going along with it. What's the plan? Well, plan's to get up, read that note on the ground. I don't think Wallaby's gonna snap out of it and just be 100% fine. He's gonna be groggy for a little bit. He's gonna be not. He's gonna be a little bit out of it. She dropped paper. I know it's right there on the ground. I see it. They killed Duke. They didn't. Shut up. I'm gonna sneeze. Oh, they're here.
Hello?
Scout. Perfect timing, man. Perfect.
Hello? Anybody in here? All right, coming in.
Holy fuck.
Oh, fuck.
No! Wait, Wallaby? What happened? Wallaby.
Fuck. Okay, we gotta get him out of here. We gotta get him out. Where the fuck is Peaches?
Where's Irene?
Where's Peaches?
Irene!
Timmy!
Hell no. Where is she?
I don't know. Okay, fuck.
Irene!
The paper! The paper!
Take him back and walk, keep looking.
Irene, where are you?
The note!
You guys keep looking. I'm gonna take him to Ansburg. If you don't find her, come back to Ansburg and meet with me.
He did see. He did see it. So when I wake up, I can get them to come back and get it. Unless they're still checking the property. I'm so glad Timmy was there for that.
Fuck,
that's sick.
Wallaby.
Drooling. We don't have to do the drool, man. We're good. Where you taking me, man? Here? Perfect.
Any fucking deputies? Oh. Nothing. Fuck.
The deputies, man. Just wake me up. Throw me in
Hello?
The river.
Is there any law in there? Hello? Anyone?
I bet you Disby finds the letter, man. I just say DEG, man. Sliding off.
Okay.
No injuries. I know I got... Yeah, no injuries. I don't want to confuse him with cougar stuff. Should give him the clue. That should give him the clue.
Okay, well, there's no doctor here. Fuck me. Oh. See anything wrong? Yes, yes. Can you hear me?
All right.
They're looking for her. We're gonna find her, Wallaby. Don't speak unless you got something. What about your injuries?
So.
Okay, we're gonna go find the rest. I'm gonna get you to Rhodes. There's some doctors there. We're gonna take care of you. We're gonna find Irene.
Yeah. I took her.
Do you know where they took her?
I fucked off.
You don't worry about that right now, Wallaby. We gotta get you to a safe place, and we need to get Irene back.
To keep her safe. I fucked up again like I did with Husky and Missy.
It's gonna be alright, Wallaby. Fuck, they're not here. Fuck me. It's gonna be alright, alright? We're gonna find her.
Wallaby's in no state to think about the note right now.
I'm sure you did everything in your power to help keep her safe. Just hang in there.
The note won't despawn because she placed it. Mini gun tricks were done, no worries, Cat. Shut up! We got drugged, man. We got drugged and they
fuck
took...
Fuck out of the way!
Oh my god. We got drugged and they took Peaches.
Shouldn't take us too long.
Is that Law? I can't tell the fucking glitching camera. Mr. Larson, 37 months. Thank you, man.
Wallaby, are you awake? CK, is there anything you can tell me about these people? Anything that I have to go off of?
Oh, fucking old lady. Shame. She was with another lady. Sister. Everything seemed nice. They gave me a cup of tea. I tried to fight them, but I couldn't.
and they took her.
Fuck. Gonna get you to Rhodes. There's some doctors there. It's gonna be all right. I promise you. You need something. I'm gonna get you there so somebody can look after you and go back out there and find her.
I wanna go to sleep. Paper. I know about the paper. Calm down, man. I'm gonna go back for the paper if they didn't find it, okay? Just give Wallaby time to recover a little bit. Jesus. We're fucked up. Man, this arc is something else. It's like every time that we think, like, oh, what are we gonna do next? Like, fuck. Every time. He'll find the paper. It's his job. We'll see.
Don't go to sleep, Wallaby. You need to stay awake. No, no sleeping.
Yeah, I'll try.
Stay awake, Wallaby. Awake, awake.
I'm awake. I let my guard down, Scout. They seem nice enough. I thought I had it under control.
You can't blame yourself for this, Wallaby.
Yeah. I was there to protect her. Seems like it's my fault to me.
Yeah, if you want to play that game, I should have been there 20 minutes ago. Maybe it would have got to you sooner. But right now, we need to focus on finding her and making sure she's all right.
Oh, yeah. We'll find her.
Yeah, your fault. It's the best, man. I love,
We've got Alvin and Timmy searching for her currently.
Making mistakes is so important to Wallaby. Like, it's like one of the most fundamental things with the character. It's what humanizes him, makes him more relatable, is that he fucks up a lot. He's got major flaws, man. His biggest flaw is his ego, right? His ego. And the whole gun trick might be, it might have seemed like a whole, like, just bullshit wasting time, but that was very important. Because him doing that showed that he was getting comfortable, and then stroking his ego They had him.
Is there a doctor here?
He dropped his guard.
Idea.
It disarmed him.
I don't even know what the fuck. Yeah, I guess he's been fucking drugged or something.
Saying is a kind of weird in here.
Oh, hello there, sir. My name's Tilly May. I'm a medic here.
Oh,
what's your name?
Sound lovely.
Oh,
are you open to being a dancing girl?
Excuse me?
Would you like to dance? I'm sure you have lovely ankles. I can't see you. Where are you?
I'm just here next to you. I'm sorry, what's your name again?
Hey, my name's Richard Eastwick.
It's a pleasure to meet you, Mr. Eastwood. My name's Tilly May. I'm just going to have a look at you over here. Are you in pain at all?
I have some sweet tea. Where are you? I'm trying to touch you.
I'm right beside you here. You drank some sweet tea. Where did your sweet tea come from?
I had a cup of tea from a dirty old hag. And next thing I know, I'm stumbling and mumbling, and I need to get on my feet right now.
All right. It's nice and easy. The doctor, this gentleman has been presented with, he's drinking some sort of tea. He said that he got it from...
Yeah.
Doesn't she sound lovely?
Said that the tea came from a lady. We're not too sure what's in it. I'm just trying to work out what we could do here.
Something we can do, a simple plan is, get some brandy and some blankets and literally have him sweat out any toxins. We can also give him a charcoal water mixture to drink, which will soak up.
I was just thinking charcoal as well. Something to sort of help with that.
I would get up right now.
I would start with the charcoal water mixture while you get him comfortable, and then that hopefully is enough to soak up whatever's in the system. If it's still in his stomach. I have to run to a thing in Saint Denis, but...
No, that's quite all right.
You leave me with her. She'll take care of me.
Oh, yeah, she's an excellent medic. She will be more than sufficient.
What'd you say your name was again?
Tilly May.
Tilly May? Have we met before?
I'm not too sure. What did you say your name was again? I'm sorry.
Richard Eastwick. I want to tell you something, Tilly. There's a fundamental problem with your doctor's office.
Oh, what's that?
It doesn't have any walls or floors.
Oh, I see. Well, I believe that's possibly the tea that you've had here. I'm going to do is I'm going to mix you up a sort of... Well, I'm not going to call it a tea because it's definitely not a tea. It's going to taste quite retro, actually. But I'm going to get you to try and drink it as best you can, all right?
Yeah,
it's going to help you much better. All right.
Put it in.
All right. Well, okay, Wallaby. Yep. Right.
Who's that fucking laughing?
The others are still out.
Is that the fucking... Someone's having a good old time.
Yeah. Sounds like it. Don't worry, you got the others are searching. I'm here if you need anything.
Where is everybody?
They're out searching.
You all right there, mate?
Who is that?
Hey, Wallaby.
Who is that?
It's Jojo.
It's gentlemen,
Jojo, let me
your
breath.
Excuse me?
Both of you, would you mind just stepping up for a moment? Just stepping to the side so that I can get the tea to him. Sorry,
yeah.
Thank you.
There we
are. Lovely. All right. Now, Mr. Eastwick, I'm going to sit you up gently here, and I'm going to give you this mixture here. It's nice and easy, just slow sips.
All right.
What the fuck happened to him?
I don't even know.
Tell me when.
Here we are. explosives. Yes, just...
He's slurping that shit, holy fuck. What the fuck are you doing?
Alright. Now just try and sit still for me. Stuff. It's probably going to make you quite ill, but it's going to help sort of alleviate whatever you've taken.
Right, right. Oh, now, yeah, I feel it.
Let's try and sit you up a little bit, nice and easy.
There you are.
Oh. Right, nice and steady.
Yeah, I feel good.
Oh dear.
She mentioned some brandy. The alcohol? Do I need to go get some of that?
I would just hold off on the brandy for just a moment, just while he's had this, because, I mean, it could induce a slight vomiting, which we don't want, but, I mean, we do want, actually, if anything, to get that stuff horrible. Out of his system.
He's so out of it, man.
Mr. Eastwick, I'm going to try and get you to sit nice and steady here.
Yeah, all right, I'll get back up again, I'll try again.
All right, nice and easy. Here we go.
I'll try and sit down in the chair.
I'm so sorry, sir.
Help me up.
We can get him up here.
Would you mind helping? I'm so sorry.
Come on, mate.
Yeah, all right.
Come on.
Yeah,
up
I'll
we
sit
go.
Down on the chair.
Go on.
Yeah. There we go. I've made it.
Much better. All right.
I can tell you've got some killer ankles under those boots, don't you, Telly? Let's just say your dad's, let's say, can you give me a little jiggle? Yeah.
There's something in his system,
I can tell.
Yes, Mr. Eastwick, I'm a very happy married, woman, and
that's
I'm a medic.
That's alright, you can just, no one's gonna touch ya.
Excuse me?
Yeah. Hello, my baby, hello, my honey. Hello, my ragtime. What the fuck do you want?
You good? You're being weirder than...
I don't feel too good.
If you feel like throwing up, you need to encourage it.
I'm going
to
throw up.
Okay.
I'm going to move away from the rug. Hold on. Something's
not right in China.
Looking at Eddie's hemorrhoids. Yep, get it out. Go on.
Outside if you can. Outside.
He might not be able to make it. I'll make it. Where's outside?
straight ahead.
To your left, Wallaby. Come on.
I don't see it. Did you say my left?
Right there, Wallaby.
Where is it?
The door was just this way.
Hold on. No, I'm all right. Nothing came out. I'm fine.
Okay. All right. Out the door. There we go.
So fucking weird today.
Where is it? Fuck.
Yep. Go on. Mm-hmm. Straight out the door. There we go. Very good.
I don't see it, man.
Nice gentle breath of air. How do you feel now?
I'm feeling great. Feeling swell. It's not puke.
All right.
I thought I was gonna throw up, but I think I'm all right.
I'm glad you're all right. Mr. Eastwick, do you have a telegram number?
Yes, it's Nutsack 591. I did vomit.
I see. Well, if you need any further medical care, you know how to reach us by telegram medics. And I possibly would recommend staying away from ladies that just try to offer you tea.
Right, of course, yeah. That won't happen again.
Damn it, man.
Now, you might find a loss of appetite over the next couple of days.
It took it out!
What I'm going to suggest to you is to drink as much water as you can. But don't drink it in large gulps, sort of sipping at it throughout the day.
This is good. We gotta let it happen.
Don't you fucking puke. That's a lawful law.
I think I'm alright.
Oh, God.
That's it. Get it all out your system.
You can't tell him, don't you dare. He's sick.
Yes, it's better out than in this case.
I think I'm alright now. I'm fine. Yeah, I'm good.
You know, a cadet's gonna have to clean. Oh,
it's all green.
Did you pass it was pink?
Oh, that is really gross. Oh, that is really gross.
I can't look away.
I'm not feeling so good.
Oh, no.
Don't, that looks so disgusting.
Don't. Stand up right now.
I'm starting to feel a bit better now, though, actually, if you ask me. I'm getting off this fucking porch.
Yeah, I think I'm alright.
Make sure you don't slip off.
Yeah, I feel a bit better. Right. I appreciate that, Tilly.
Do you have water?
Yeah, I got water. I'll go get some at the well. Listen, all honesty though, if this whole medic thing don't pan out, you come see me, alright?
Thank you. And I suppose I should telegram you at
Nutsack 591.
Lovely. Thank
That's
you.
Right. You reach out to me. I'll give you some work.
Alright, thank
all
you.
Alright. Thank you, deputies.
Jesus fucking Christ.
I need a. We gotta find Irene.
Wait, whoa, put away the gun. What do you mean you gotta find Irene?
No, you never you mind, I got it under control.
She's my friend. Why do you need to find Irene?
Well, she's missing, obviously.
Why do you have your gun out?
Because I'm gonna shoot the old hag in the fucking head is what I'm gonna do.
What old hag?
The old fucking hag that gave me the tea.
Okay, well, Wallaby.
Yeah.
We can go find her together, alright?
Alright, let's go to the saloon, let's get one together. We gotta mount the fuck up. What?
Alright.
What does the old lady look like? She's like an old fucking hag. What do you want?
Real quick, can you lay down for just a second? Like, yeah, just lay down. You got some puke on you. Here, just lay there for a second. Okay, there we go.
Jay, right. Thanks. Appreciate that.
Yeah.
Wait, does the old lady know a younger lady?
Yeah.
Dark hair?
Yeah, that's the one.
Howdy, all.
Hello.
Howdy.
Being a good boy today, Wallaby?
Yeah, I'm being a great boy. Why?
I'm just curious. I know you told me you're trying to go on the straight and narrow.
And that's what I'm doing.
Well, good. I'm just double checking.
You know what you should do? You should be doing internal investigations because you got a creeper fucking problem.
What do you mean by that?
Oh, you'll find out one day.
Take care of yourselves now.
All right. Oh, we need to find Alvin and Timmy and see if they found that fucking letter. If they didn't, we got to go back up. Is she leaving? Where is she going? JoJo's getting involved.
Okay, yeah, sounds great.
Yeah, Wallaby.
Oh yeah, I know him. I did a couple jobs for him.
Wallaby, we have a problem.
Oh fuck me, I don't have time.
Okay, what do I do about this?
What the fuck, Harry?
Get off the horse.
Okay, but don't hurt him.
Go on, get.
Oh,
lovely, lovely. Okay. I feel like we can deal with this later. We have something more pressing at hand at the moment.
All right, who came up with y'all?
Okay, I'll handle
Alvin and Timmy.
Where are they?
They're out searching
for her. Did you tell
them? Yeah, I telegrammed them, told them I was here.
All right, we need a group back up, and we need to talk about this. What?
I think I saw them.
Well,
it's like a creepy old lady and a younger lady who is equally creepy.
Yeah. Well.
I don't think
by the fucking swamps.
No, this is not progress.
Which swamp?
I need to point out the exact fucking. above Blue Water Marsh.
All right, let me.
They're being all fucking weird, and they were talking about a lady that was inside that was heartbroken over a breakup. She's in my fucking room.
All right, let me get my horse.
You get your fucking horse. Leave that. Just come on.
So, shit.
Are you sure you're good to ride a horse? Okay.
Yes.
Thank you for the reassurance. Good job, Harry.
What are you in a fit state to be on a horse right now?
What do you think? Let's fucking go.
Alright, come. Yep, alright.
Shut up. Where the fuck are we going? Which way? Which fucking way?
This way.
Alright.
Come on, this way. You're giving a Rennie impression right now. Are a dangerous weapon.
You sure you don't need to be on like the back of his horse or something?
Shut the fuck up and leave me the way.
Okay.
They got my girl.
In front of you.
I fucking am, alright? It's fucking foggy. Where's the house? Doing fucking talking, all right? All right. We know you're in there. Now you've got 20 seconds to bring Irene out. I'm gonna shove my fucking gun up your ass and pull. Till it clicks, you understand?
Their horse is gone.
Their horse is gone.
Now the horse here, black and white one. The younger lady was on it.
Fuck.
There's no one in here.
Fuck.
All right.
Hang on. When I was up there, before I passed out, she was looming over me, whispering some fucking bullshit, and something slipped out of her garment thing. Like a piece of paper or something. Did you grab it?
No. Maybe Timmy or Alvin did.
Oh, we gotta go check. You sure that we're here?
I'm sure. Describe what they look like. Was the older lady wearing a dress?
Yeah, like a green gown or something.
Yep. That's my...
All right. Come on, Duke.
That's mutiny.
We missed them, man. I'm glad they weren't there. Glad, I tell ya, glad. They didn't go very far, man. It must have been just a pit stop. I feel like, yeah, they didn't go very far at all.
Oh, did we fucking checked around, right?
Yup, we checked the lightning place. We checked all the buildings.
All right. Did you pick up the piece of paper in the house?
There was a piece of paper?
Yeah, come on.
Okay, we need to get it.
Telegram. I'll check it on the way back. Away. foolish daughter, why run away from home? Mother knows best for you, dear. She always has.
You got it?
I know that's... Yeah. Says, foolish daughter, why run away from home? Mother knows best for you, dear. She always has. I know that sooner or later you will come back, leaving all your things here. Foolish girl. Come home, Nelly. Mother knows best. I'm gonna chop her fucking head off.
Yeah, I'll be right there to hold her still while you do it. Any ideas?
No. No, I don't.
Seemed Jojo was near the swamp.
They're heading down south, but they could have taken a route west. I don't fucking know. There's so many places. Let's go to Annisburg.
I don't know where we lost Alvin or Timmy yet.
Nelly? Yeah, they call her Nelly. Waterfall? Yeah, that's where she goes to hide. That's not where they would have taken her, though. I already thought about the waterfall.
She was telling me...
I'll check it out in a second. I don't think there's anything behind it.
She told me the story of her parents. She mentioned something about Mount Hagen ages ago. I don't know if that could have anything to do with anything.
Mount Hagen were different people.
Oh, okay.
That might be worth checking. I don't know.
It also doesn't make sense. Why would they go all the way to the swamps to go to Mount Hagen, which is so far away?
So many people want work. James Kelly told Mills to give you my cut as a down payment. Let me know how much you need. Fuck, I need to get Dude, we need guns. Fuck.
I'm actually not too sure right now.
I don't think we're really sure at all.
Even with, you know, what we've uncovered?
We haven't uncovered shit.
Was there nothing left behind there?
Just a letter. All we know is they're headed down this way. Which means, did you come up this way when you came over to us?
Yes.
Yeah.
You might have rode right by them.
No way!
We rode by one person. I didn't see anybody with them, though.
Let's check the houses around Emerald Ranch. Follow me. I think the swamp was definitely the place. But I think Jojo running into them spooked them and they moved. If I had to guess. so good, man. I don't want to farm tonight, honestly. Dandelions, maybe? There's a few clues, but we don't know. Man, the way that Minx yelled at Richard actually getting taken away, heartbreaking, dude. Mysteria flower. Well, Wallaby didn't see that flower. I don't think they would have left the east.
Let me check the fort.
Yeah, have a quick look inside.
Oh, we already did. I can check again.
We did bump into this fella here. He went by the name Winston. Was wearing all black.
Was he old?
No, he wasn't.
Not them.
If you don't mind my asking, who was it y'all met with?
Some people from her past.
Oh, shit.
They didn't. They seem to dislike the West with like the dust and everything, so I don't think they're out that way. It'd be somewhere. If I had to put a circle, it'd be like around here. Somewhere around here. Which is a lot of places, man.
Maybe we check there, the building east of us.
Where were they first at?
He wants to check
was it
this
from
one.
Down in by the city or up?
Well, Innsbruck.
Okay, and that means the place that I saw them at is already
south of Innsbruck.
They went up again.
I'm thinking the big house that's east of us, maybe.
The thing is that they went past that already. Turning back around would risk running into us or me coming back down that way.
It's a bit weird to do a U-turn when you got someone.
Wait, I thought you said they came from the house past Innsbruck going south.
Yeah, but we
yeah,
spotted
and I saw them
down south.
Yeah, a house
south.
That's more south for me.
Right.
We spotted them? Okay.
Let's go down this way. So there's so many places, man, really. And like in character, Wallaby wants to find her. OOC, I don't, so. I'm probably gonna self-sabotage in a second and be like, I'm too sick, I can't keep looking. Just to stop the search, you know? What, why? Cause I don't wanna find them, man. I want them to be able to roleplay through this over time, not just in the same day. Like, imagine if we ended the husky thing in one stream. That would have sucked. Wallaby wouldn't quit, though. I know, that's what I'm trying to figure out, a way out. Like, in character, there has to be a way out. Otherwise, if we want to do what Wallaby would do, we're going to be here for fucking 6 hours searching. Do you want that? Yes, I shouldn't have asked that question. Nothing. Alright, this way.
Are you sure you're good to keep going?
Yeah. Run into something, I don't know. Thank you, man. Stop saying the waterfall. That was her place, not theirs. They're not gonna take it to the fucking waterfall. How have they lost me? I'm going at such a slow pace. That might have been a server crash, I'm not sure. There's the excuse! Just vanish. Would that be funny though if I just logged out and left and everyone else is like, okay, so Irene's gone and now Wallaby's missing, what the fuck? Getting a little hungry, man. Probably gonna end shortly, go have some lunch. Ah, bro. Any news about Texas Chainsaw Massacre? That game's gotta be out soon, right? That technical test has to be any day now, right? Let me see if they've tweeted anything. Oh, they did 10 hours ago, but nothing about the technical test. Damn it. Son of a bitch. Well, that explains why we lost him. And I got no horse now. Motherfucker. I think Emerald's over here, right? I'm gonna send a telegram to Scout and be like, I'm going off to find her myself. Look after the saloon for me. And we'll just roleplay that Wallaby's looking around for her. And we'll just let them kill her. You know? Fantastic. Nah. They don't plan to kill her, man. They got some other bullshit in mind, I can tell. It's, Scout's Twitch name. It's Ethan Shriver, I believe. And then Scout will be looking for you for God knows how long. No, I'm gonna make sure I put it in the telegram. Don't look for me. So I really don't want to find her yet. I want this arc to be a thing, an ongoing thing. We'll go Scout. We're gonna do Scout dirty. Scout. Wallaby. Riding as a pack was slowing me down. I'm going to keep looking for her alone. If I see them, I will telegram you right away so we can get these motherfuckers together. Run the saloon while I am gone. Wallaby. P.S. OOC. I'm just hungry and want to log out. Send. I'm not fucking with you. No. Yeah, there you go. Gotta go fast before they check over here, man. Let's log here. Alright. Now, in our imaginary world, Wallaby's totally looking for her, alright, guys? Alright? I promise. That's exactly what's happening. He's out there searching through all the thicket. All right, let's sing it to somebody. So dumb. Dude, you're dumb. All right? It's called turning a one-day fucking RP into several days of RP. All right? No need to end, man. That was beautiful today. And that scene deserves more than just being found in an hour and shutting it down and killing them. Money in the bank, man. I'm gonna sing to somebody. I'll see you probably tomorrow. Probably. Thank you guys for watching. Sorry it's a bit shorter today, but trust me, this is worth. If I had continued, it'd be just another 2 hours of us searching and me not really wanting to find him. And that just sounds lame. So I'd prefer just to RP that we've been looking around and continue the story next time. I'll see you later. Bye.